And however you want to listen, you can listen for free on the Bison 1660 mobile app. Download it today on your app store and listen live to the Insiders, Fox Sports Radio, and all of our coverage of NDSU athletics. The Bison 1660 app, powered by Thunder Seed. Thunder Seed, first in the field.
Corwin Toyota's lot is overflowing with used vehicles, and it's time to clear them out. Find the biggest selection of used cars, trucks, SUVs, and vans. All makes, all models, all priced to sell. Shop their huge selection of certified pre-owned Toyotas. It's the next best thing to new. Certified pre-owned vehicles come with an exceptional coverage policy. Each unit undergoes a 160-point inspection to ensure only the best. Receive the certified seal of approval. Shop Corwin Toyota today. CorwinToyota.com.
Dakota Refrigeration has been helping the Bison succeed behind the scenes. From their training room to their dining room, from milk to medicine, from ice to ice cream, Dakota Refrigeration has been serving Minnesota, Montana, and the Dakotas for over four decades. Locally owned and operated since 1974, Dakota Refrigeration is a full-service source for your refrigeration, heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and electrical needs. Dakota Refrigeration, located in Fargo, Bismarck, and Minot.
Truck headquarters. Gateway Chevrolet has new Chevy trucks arriving daily. Buy your new Chevy Silverado at invoice. Yes, invoice pricing on new Silverados with a fresh look, new interiors, and larger screens with easy-to-use technology. Save thousands on new Chevy Silverados with four different motors available. Dynamic fuel management, Bluetooth, backup camera, Apple CarPlay, and more. Save thousands and enjoy the smooth ride in your new Chevy Silverado from Gateway Chevrolet. Find new roads. Details, gatewayfargo.com.
KQWB, West Fargo, Fargo-Moorhead, and KPFX, HD3, Kindred, Bison 1660. Powered by Gateway Chevrolet, Cadillac, Nissan, and Hyundai in Fargo.
We are Buffalo!
And here's what you need to know.
The Texans have made a change in their front office. Reports say Houston has fired Vice President of Football Operations, Jack Easterby. Axios reports the Titans and Nashville Mayor John Cooper have reached the deal to build a new dome stadium for the team. It still needs to be approved by Nashville Metro Council. NFL Media says Chargers receiver Keenan Allen won't play tonight against the Broncos. For Denver, they are expected to activate All-Pro safety Justin Simmons for the game. The Times-Picayune reports the Saints don't expect to have receivers Michael Thomas or Jarvis Landry against the Cardinals on Thursday night. They're optimistic Chris Olave will play. In the NBA, reports say Rockets guard Kevin Porter Jr. has agreed to a four-year, $82.5 million extension, and ESPN reports Trailblazers forward Nasir Little agreed to a two-year, $28 million extension. I'm Nick Cope.
You've got the insiders.
How you play today, from this moment on, is how you will be remembered.
That's what living is.
That's right.
There's 6 inches in front of your face.
Bringing you what you need to know and a whole lot more. Topics you care about, guests you know, and the conversations you came to hear. The Insiders are presented by ProSeed. Need seed? Think ProSeed.
This is your time. Now go out there and take it.
Oh, baby.
Now, here are the Insiders.
The Insiders.
The Insiders.
The Insiders.
Insiders.
Bison great Kyle Emanuel and the voice of the Bison, Rob Hipp.
Oh, no, no, no. Here we go on a Monday. Many of you are wondering what's going on. Who is this guy sitting in the hot seat? It's a little spicy over here today, despite the cold weather outside. Rob Pipp here. Andy Rickoff has left us for the week. So, Andy, if you're out there, we'll miss you this week, but have fun. We'll talk a little bit about that a little bit later on. Bison great Kyle Emanuel here in the Tharaldson Ethanol broadcast studio. Good to have you, man. What's going on?
It's good to be back, Rob. You know, I sat in this chair for a little bit. It was a little bit over a month, and so it's it's good to be back, man, and get to enjoy a little bit of a bye week, but always great to be back and, you know, talking Bison football and the world of sports that it is.
It's a lot going on right now, man. Football, we were talking basketball earlier last week. Everything's starting to come together. But today, we've got just an action-packed show. Micah Bindy also joined. Micah, what's going on with you, man? How was your weekend after, you know, it was a tough Saturday. How was your weekend, man?
I just had a relaxing Sunday. Had to kind of let the game soak in a little bit. Not that it was a Could have been a more enjoyable game, obviously. Not the result that NDSU wanted, not the result that we wanted. But, hey, we got this bye week. We're going to come off of it steamrolling. It's going to be great.
Can we please start today positively? Look, I know there's a lot. We're going to be positive today. There's a lot to be thankful for, so I'm going to lead you with that. If you guys know me, I'm a pretty inspirational guy. I like to talk good about things that are going on. Kyle, you're that kind of guy too, man.
No, I'm not.
You're not? What are you going to throw at us today, man?
I'll be positive. I'm always positive when it comes around Bison football in general. I'm never going to hate on the boys, because I know how hard it is, and I know how much goes into it. But, you know, I'll balance you out a little bit, Rob. I could be the pessimistic side over here if you need me to be.
Yeah, I need you to be.
But, I'll there was also a saying when I was a player, you know, fake it till you make it. You know, there's some days you go out to practice, you're not feeling so good, you get in the weight room, you just don't have the energy. Well, you just got to fake it sometimes, and then that'll bring you around. So I can fake a lot of positivity today if you need me to.
Positivity is contagious.
We'll make That's it right. work out. Well, hey, we got a good show. I want to welcome everybody in, and thanks for being a part of it today. Again, Andy's on vacation. He said something about a tent by himself, a rental car, and the mountains. And I said, dude, wherever you're going, don't let any bears eat you. And he told me, he's like, man, where I'm going, I may have to eat the bears. So we're hoping everything with him is going to be all right this week.
Yeah, you know, I was in Glacier. It was actually going to some weddings, and that's why I was gone for a couple games there at the beginning of the year. And I was in Glacier National Park, and I came across a bear, too, actually. And you don't want to mess around with those things. I mean, like, literally 10 yards in front of me, a bear crossed the trail path that we were walking on. So, yeah, Andy, I hope you're prepared out there because, you know, you get out in the wild, you never know what's going to happen. So, yeah, we wish him nothing but the best and a healthy return for next week.
Yeah, so we're going to miss you this week, but we're here holding it down again. Kyle Emanuel joining us. Appreciate you being here, Kyle. Hey, of course, look, I didn't want to take 3 or 4 minutes to get into it, but we are going to talk NDSU, SDSU. We've got to talk about that. It's also Overreaction Monday. Sometimes the guys here call it the meat sandwich. And I'll be honest, man, I don't eat breakfast. I'm on this new diet right now, one of these fasting diets. It's actually working. I've dropped about 7 pounds, but it's worked out because I typically don't eat breakfast anyways. Don't know how many of you are on something like that or if it's worked for you. Bridget says she's in nursing, so she's like, that's not healthy. But whenever I hear the word on a Monday morning, like a meat sandwich of overreaction, I kind of get a little sick to my stomach, man. I don't want a meat sandwich early in the morning.
Hey, man, I'll take a meat sandwich right now. Always. I'm a big breakfast guy, Rob. So, I mean, I'm always – I got to have something in the morning. I don't – you know, is it like intermittent fasting? Is that what you're getting
at? Yeah, I'm on like a 14-10 right now. It works.
Yeah.
14
I'm
on,
sure
10
it
off.
Does, but I just – I've never – I tried like a 10-day diet challenge once, and that was about enough for me.
It works, man. And it also works with Micah Bendy. Finally, that facial hair is coming back. So do not ever shave again, man. Keep that thing going. Phil Hansen hopefully will join us at 11:30. Word on the street was he barged out of town too, man. From what I heard, I think he may have – I mean, he may have went out of the country. So he told me if I have coverage, I will call in. So the game plan is to have Phil on at 11:30. I messaged him earlier, so hopefully we'll hear from Phil. We're also going to talk a little bit about other things going on at NDSU. You know, there's a lot of positive things going on around campus with soccer and those things. So wanted to make sure we highlight some of that. We're also going to look around the Missouri Valley Football Conference. You know, as I went off the air the other day, I said something about the schedule gets easier. That was false. It does not get easier for North Dakota State. We're going to go over that. That was just me, again, trying to be way too positive. You got to be real at some point. Things do not get easier, and it's not easy to win a college football game to begin with. But, hey, this Valley – and we'll talk about it a little bit more, Kyle, but I really feel like where is the bottom to the Valley this year?
Yeah, I mean, you look at the rest of the schedule, and, you know, you think Indiana State is at the bottom, and they are record-wise. They lost again last week to Youngstown State, but we saw in Terre Haute, Indiana State is no pushover, so that's a team that could probably upset anyone. South Dakota is 1-5, I believe, but 4 of those losses are to really good teams, and then they lose at the buzzer to Illinois State, who NDSU has next. You look at the next 4 games for NDSU, Illinois State, Western, Southern Illinois, and North Dakota. I'll point to Southern right away. They were a team you look at early on, and they're 0-2. They drop some games, and you're just like, okay, Southern's not who we thought they were. And all they've done since is win every single game. So that looks like a massive game down there in Carbondale. And then you have to point to, obviously, the last game of the year in North Dakota, and UND playing some really good football, another rivalry. So – no, I agree with you, Rob. I don't think it gets any easier, and you can't overlook Illinois State either. They've been doing some good things lately, too.
Yeah, so we'll dig into that a little bit more. Matt Larsen, athletic director at NDSU, going to come in and join us around 12:15, so we appreciate Matt being here. and we're going to catch up with all things NDSU. I'm excited. NODAC Insurance, the Football Performance Complex, opening up. And I know that the title is Football Performance Complex, but it's being utilized for all sports. So we'll hear more about that. It was great to be out there on Friday to see the community support. And you talk about a world-class facility that rivals even FBS schools at this moment. Now, Dr. Cook was being kind of like me. He was being really positive and said, I think this thing's better than the Vikings training facility. Hey, I don't know if it's that good, but it's pretty darn good for college football. So appreciate him and all that he does as well. We'll also go over the polls. Hey, we already have the coaches poll that came out a little bit earlier. We've got the update on that as North Dakota State has dropped to number 4. So we do have that. We'll go over that as well. Maybe a little bit of NFL talk, Vikings, Commanders, see what's going on around there. You know, Vikings, I didn't get a chance to watch whole games just because of everything going on, but I will say this. Whenever you only had those 15 yards in the first half of that ball game and the first 25 minutes or so, a little bit surprised. But, hey, Vikings, one loss on the season. Hey, we'll take it, man. The official Micah Bendy making a noise back there, letting us know what's going on. And maybe a little MLB playoff updates. Yeah. There's been some exciting games. Right. You know, hey, guys, I don't want to talk Texas forever, but that's what I know. That's where I came from. I'm excited for the Astros. Really am. I don't know about anybody else around here. Are you guys over the cheating? Is that over with, or is it still everyone's minds?
I'm kind of over it. I'm not I love baseball. I love the sport of baseball. I don't pay attention to it as much as I probably should. But I'll ask you then, Rob. Who do you want, Guardians or Yankees? That's who they got.
Oh,
right?
The Guardians, man.
Yeah, you don't want to see the Yankees. You don't want to beat the Yankees.
No, I want a Guardians to take that series.
Okay.
Because I do not want to see the Yankees. You know, it's just one of those things because they win so much, but I do not want to see the Yankees in there this season. I want to see the Guardians win that series, and it would be a great matchup to see Houston against those guys.
For the cheating scandal, I'm kind of over it too. It's like it's in the past, and they have a new regime in there, and they've lost some of the players that were on that team, and I think they're trying to push it past them now. Like, we're 3 years removed from it, or was it 2017?
Yeah, and you're talking
– it's been a while.
It's been a long while. Enough. So, like, statue I'm kind of over it. But for the Guardians just know how to win. That's just a baseball team. They're not, like, star-studded. They're not like the Yankees. They don't have Judge, Giancarlo Stanton, Anthony Rizzo. They're just a good overall old-fashioned baseball team that just finds a way to win.
Yeah, and I want to see that series go in the favor of the Guardians, so I will step up and say that. And man, I got to see a lot of good Astros games over the years when I was down in Southeast Texas, but happy to be here. We're loving it. We're getting moved in. So maybe we'll talk a little bit about that. Hey, I want to remind our listeners, too, the email is open on the Rick Electric email inbox. You can email us studio@bison1660.com. Again, studio@bison1660.com. We will get to those throughout the show as well. And maybe we should hop right in. I mean, let's go right to the Epic Companies hotline. Jim is already joining us from Fargo. Jim, good morning. Hey, man, how you doing?
Good, Rob and Kyle. Great to see you guys, especially you, Rob. Do you think the defense is – they got lots of holes in it. Do you think the injuries are hurting us, or just the teams are figuring us out?
I think it's a combination of that and maybe even something else. And, Jim, thank you for calling in. And then, of course, I'll let Kyle hop in too here in a moment. But, man, you look at this team and the success they've had over the years, but that rush defense just hasn't been there this year. And we talk about guys being out like Eli Mostard, and that's difficult. We're still waiting on guys. And I'm never going to single out one single player. That's not me. We know it's a team effort. There's been glimpses at that linebacker position. Who's going to step up? We've seen James Kaiser do some great things this season. But I think there is still some concern there, obviously. The tackles are continuing to be missed. It wasn't as bad at Indiana State, maybe a few more. But also you're playing against a running back named Isaiah Davis, who, you know, another game over 100 yards. I got to see him firsthand when Sam Houston played him in the national championship. So there's still some work, obviously, that's got to be done there. I think a lot of it is just guys having to step up, and the bye week is coming at a good time.
There's a lot of things to point to there, Rob. And it is a concern. I think, you know, to Jim's point there, I would point out that there are 7 guys between graduation and injuries along that front 7 that are no longer there from a year ago. So, you know, we talked all the talk in the preseason was how much is coming back for NDSU, how good they are, how talented they are, how, you know, it's them versus the field. But, you know, you kind of fail to appreciate some of the impact that some of those guys had that are no longer there. Some guys that, like I said, that graduated, some guys that are injured, and I think Eli Mostar is the guy you have to point to first and foremost. Like you said, it's never one guy, but they're missing him up front. And you know, and me and Micah were talking about this before the show. You know, is it X's and O's? Is it just tackling? Are they just it's a combination of all of it, I think. I think one thing you've seen, we saw South Dakota State do a ton of pre-snap motion. Now, what does that do for you as a defender? Well, it changes your gap. It forces you to communicate, and you have to do it now because it's happening. They're motioning, and then they're snapping the ball immediately. It causes slight confusion. So we saw some of that. We've seen teams spread NDSU out and trying to defend the run with a light box, and sometimes it just comes down to, can you get a guy to win the one-on-one? You know, there's going to be times, depending on what defense you're in, if you're in a two-high defense, you might be a gap short. You might need a guy to just win. You know, you got this gap run two, you got this gap run away. You got to go win, you know, and so there's that aspect of it. And then the thing that you have to point to the most is just tackling. You know, there's been times this year where NDSU's fit up the run perfectly. They have a guy, maybe two guys right there, and just unable to make the tackle. And to your point, Rob, they've played some really good running backs. Now, I'm not trying to make excuses at all, but they've played some really good backs. You think of Jaleel McLaughlin. I really like Travis Tice from South Dakota. Obviously, Isaiah Davis. They've played some good backs. So that's a long way of saying it's a little bit of everything. I don't know if I could just point to one certain thing.
Yeah, and we'll see how they mold and continue. And again, that bye week, sometimes you think, okay, the bye week's coming after a loss. That's tough. You're going to sit around and maybe just soak that in and think about it too much. But I don't think so. I think even though these are young guys, 18 to 22, this coaching staff does a good job telling them, hey, let's put that behind us. I don't think it's an issue of the players living in the past, because we saw at Arizona, came out a little bit soft in that next game, but then came on to be victorious. So I think it's those things that the coaching staff does, saying, look, guys, this is a good time for the bye week. I don't like how I see it worded as an off week, because nobody gets off.
No.
It is not an off week, even though it's technically coined as an off week. We call it the bye week because it's you don't play, but you're not off. You're working hard. Again, appreciate that, and want to remind you that Epic Companies hotline is open throughout our show. As always, Epic Companies, the area's premier real estate investing and development firm. You can visit them online at epiccompaniesnd.com. Kyle, wanted to say this in this segment. We're going to talk NDSU a little bit more. We're going to talk SDSU. What have you been up to, man? You're busy on the TV side. I just kind of see you all over the field, man, doing a lot.
Yeah, no, it's been fun. The fall is a busy time for me, and I'm still, you know, 2 years removed now playing football and still trying to figure it out. But for the fall so far, you know, it's been fun. I'm coaching high school football, so that keeps me busy on a daily basis. Got practice and things there. So I was actually in Bismarck, you know, Friday night, and then, you know, got back late and, you know, got all ready for the pregame show. So coaching high school football, doing the TV gig, man, it's been fun. It's just a blast for me to continue to stay around this program and to feel involved in just a small way. I obviously can't play anymore, but, you know, and I can say this now, I wasn't going to say it on the air, but that was a tough game for me to call. I'm not going to lie, you know, because you got to be impartial on the air. You don't want to show bias, and I think everyone listening knows that I'm probably going to be a little bit biased towards NDSU, but, you know, some positive things are happening there for SDSU, and it's hard for me to compliment them, but hey, man, it's been fun to be around, and, you know, I enjoy every minute of it.
That's why you need to hop over to the radio side, because we can be more 70-30.
That's right.
And I'm blessed to have Phil Hansen sitting next to me, because
he's like 90-10.
Phil's 95-5, man. Yeah. Phil, but you know, when you're a legend such as Phil Hansen, you can say what you say and keep on rolling. So it's good to have him. But man, yeah, it's good to see what you're doing. Hey, one other question too. You're coaching, you're on TV, you're being the analyst, you're here with us today. On top of all of this, you have a wife now.
Yeah, I just got married. Yeah, was it now, 2 months, a little over 2 months ago? Oh, you're approaching 3 months now. It's been flying by. You know, it's tough now because, you know, with coaching high school football, you know, I'm gone somewhat late into the evening. She's working all day. I'm gone on the weekends, you know. But married life's been great, but it's just, you know, finding time for each other, as I'm sure you're aware of, Robbie, and, you know, in a relationship as well. Sometimes it's tough to find the time, but for you, just one-on-one together. But, you know, it's been great, and, you know, she's awesome, obviously, and we're enjoying it.
All right, all the right words coming out of Kyle Emanuel's mouth here today. You got to make sure that, you know, hey, when we got that significant other, you better lift her up, and you always do that. I do that as well. You know, this industry's tough, man.
Yeah.
Because you are gone a lot. It's just like coaches. I was talking to Coach Entz, saying, hey, Coach, I don't know how coaches do. People have asked me, well, how do you do it? You're doing this, this, and this. I said, man, look, we've got the easy job. We just get to call the games and describe the action for the fans and get to be fans ourselves most of the time. the hard job is on those coaches.
Oh, yeah.
They're away from their families a lot.
That's why when people ask me, like, oh, do you ever think about getting into coaching? Like, yeah, man, I think I would love it. Outside of that, you know, the schedule and, you know, these coaches, it's not like, you know, it's not like they're done at 5 o'clock and they just get to go home and they're done for the day, you know, between practice and game planning. And then, oh, yeah, by the way, you got to recruit high school kids. You know, you're on the phone with them, calling them, texting them, doing all the things. I don't even know that side of the world, but all the things that go into recruiting, man, it's a lot. It is.
Glad that we just get to do what we do and let them do what they do with what they're good at. We appreciate the staff. Hey, people are texting us. People are emailing us. We're going to get to those before too long. For now, though, we'll step aside. We'll take a quick break. Stay with us. Jam-packed show continues. It's the Insiders brought to you by Proceed. Need seed. Think Proceed. And online at proceed.net.
Hear the herd here. Bison 1660.
We take great pride in really doing all the research and the work behind the scenes to make sure that our products just work. We have our own staff member that helps pick the hybrids and the varieties that work in our area. It's meant for you, not for somebody 200 miles away.
We test our seed locally. We produce our seed locally, so we get to see our production fields, where they need to be, and if they work there.
Need seed, think Proceed. Proceed.net, great seed at a reasonable price.
Hi, it's Kelly, and I want to tell you about my great experience with Valley Service Mechanical. They were polite and very easy to deal with. They were knowledgeable and helped me understand every step of the process, from the initial discussion of purchase options to the installation. It was a top-notch experience. If you ever want to work with professionals, I would strongly recommend Valley Service Mechanical.
When your heating and cooling needs help and your plumbing is on the fritz, call Valley Service Mechanical, 701-293-5701. Online at valleyservice.net.
On the Rocks Craft Cocktails bring natural, refreshing, bar-quality, balanced cocktails to the ready-to-drink category. Natural ingredients, no preservatives, like the Mai Tai with Caruzan Rum, the Margarita with Hornitos Tequila, an Old Fashioned with Knob Creek Bourbon, an Aviation with Larios Gin, or get spicy with a Jalapeno Pineapple Margarita with Tres Generaciones Tequila. Or maybe live it up with the Cosmopolitan with effin' Vodka. On the Rocks Craft Cocktails. Hard to choose. Easy to pour. Please drink responsibly.
Jeep Adventure Days are going on now at Corwin Jeep, and the deals are hot. Get invoice pricing on all new 2022 Jeep Compass models. That's right, you pay what we pay when you get invoice pricing on all new Jeep Compasses. And that's not all. Get financing as low as 0% on a new Compass or Renegade. All new Jeeps come with Jeep Wave, our 36-month free service plan. What are you waiting for? Shop the huge selection of new inventory today, only at Corwin Jeep. Shop online. CorwinAuto.com.
When it comes to your electrical needs, you only need one call, and that's to JDP Electric. Whether it's a small residential project or a larger commercial job, JDP's team of professionals will work with you closely to make the process easy. Their dedicated team of professionals can assist with any size project or idea you may have, and even provide a few ideas they see that fit your budget as well. Call 232-1991 today to experience the JDP difference, or online at jdpelectric.net.
30 years and counting. VI Apparel, number one in corporate, collegiate, and high school apparel. We've partnered with college bookstores and high schools to retailers to bring you high-quality game day apparel. Whether for work or play, every day is game day at CI Apparel with brands you love. Nike, Ogio, Under Armour, and the CI Sport brand. With competitive pricing and fast turnaround times, we help you work harder, play harder, and cheer harder in style. CI Apparel, 2121 43rd Street South in Fargo, and CIApparel.com.
Bison 1660.
You guys feeling that this morning? Watch out now. Kyle Emanuel's about to start singing. Do you ever just get up and start singing, Kyle?
On the air? No, never.
Are you feeling this jam right here, though,
I'm
man?
Feeling the jam, yeah, for sure.
Song is called Good Life.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
That's
see,
the positive vibes we need.
Yes, I told you, man. You come in, oh, we lost. Everything's terrible. I'm a Cowboys fan. Cowboys lost. I was kind of expecting it. Cooper Rush, 2 picks. One of them really wasn't his fault. No one cares up here. I do.
Yeah, but Cowboys 4-1 with Cooper Rush. You'd take that all day. When
every
Dak
day.
Got hurt, when Dak got hurt, someone came up to you and said, hey, we're just going to hand you 4-1. You'd be like, yeah, absolutely. I'll take that all day. And
every
you lost
day.
To, you know, arguably the best team in the league right now. They're the only undefeated team left. So, I mean, you got to have positive vibes if you're a Cowboy fan still. Dak coming back, like, you got to feel good.
Overreaction real quick. Giants? What's up? Is that are they for real now?
Yeah.
I wanted to do a deep dive on the Giants. Like, just look at their league-wide statistics in just different rankings on offense and defense. Because I'm just like, Are they a good team? Actually, they just beat the Ravens, which we always think the Ravens are a really good team. Now, because we talked about it earlier, who is playing way better than what we thought they should be? And we picked the Giants after like 3 or 4 weeks.
Both New York teams are. The Jets. Yeah, you can't overlook the Jets either, man. The Jets are doing some... Who'd they beat yesterday?
Packers.
Yeah. Going to Lambeau, and they beat the Packers? Come on now.
Yeah. There's a lot. It's no more overreaction with some of these teams. It's weird. We see it happening in the Valley right here at home, and now we're seeing it in the Pro as well. Hey, I wanted to talk. Let's get into it, man. We have got to get into it. We are 23 minutes in. We have got to get into South Dakota State.
Yeah, that's why we're here. We avoided it long enough.
We tried to avoid it. Hey, man, I was trying to avoid it post-game. I was like, hey, can we maybe do the TV interview a couple of days later? But we did it. Everything was good. We're talking about it. I've already got some texts coming in. We're going to get to you, Tony, here in a minute. I want to talk positives real quick. We've got some highlights already queued up from post-game. James Kaiser was talking about Bison Nation and how they showed up and the impact that they made.
The fall starts in the first half. What kind of impact did the atmosphere bring?
Yeah, that was amazing. I don't know if our fans watch this stuff, but thank you guys. It was an electric atmosphere today. Five fall starts. That has a huge impact on the game. That was probably one of the loudest games I've ever played in. So we thank this community, our fans. We love you guys, and there's a lot of season left, so keep supporting us.
I think it's incredible. You hear the leadership from him and James, and James is a funny guy. You get around James, he tells jokes. And I'm not saying it in a bad way. Like, he just, you know, when you look at him, you're like, this guy's a funny guy. But he also is serious when it matters, and he's been pretty serious out there on the field, leading the team in tackles this year, over 50 tackles. But, yeah, Bison Nation – we were up there. Papers literally, everyone told me this in my years at Sam Hughes. I said, just wait till you get up to the Fargo Dome on big games. Papers will be vibrating in the press box. They were doing just that. Bison Nation showed up huge.
They really did. And that's not just talk. That's not just game. James Kaiser just saying, you know, the right thing to kind of, you know, cater to the fans a little bit. Like, he's legitimately right. Like, outside, obviously, NDSU played well in that first half, especially offensively. Like, they just couldn't be stopped. But defensively, like, the crowd was literally the 12th man. Like, SDSU, now I know they struggled a little bit offensively. Obviously, they had a really good drive to start the game, but, like, they couldn't get anything going after that because they just kept getting penalties. You know, and how do you call a game when you're an offensive coordinator and every single drive it's first and 15, second and 15? You know, they had a bunch of third and longs, and that was all because of the crowd. And that was the thing, and I know we'll get into it, but, like, that was the thing in the second half was just – it was just – it wasn't existing. It wasn't the crowd's fault. It just, they were waiting for something to cheer. You just needed one stop defensively or one drive offensively to get that crowd back into it. And credit to SDSU, because that was, you know, talk about a million different things that happened in the game. That was a huge difference in the second half. They kept that Fargo Dome quiet. They stayed on track, and they limited their penalties.
I mean, what was it, like five false starts in the first half? And
two
then
back-to-back.
Yeah, their right tackle, John O'Brien. Man, that dude's ears were bleeding after the game, and he probably got a little spanking there from the coach, man.
Do you have Phil Hansen's his soundbite queued up, Micah?
That guy needs help.
That's right. That's right. That guy needed help in the first half, and it wasn't just the false starts. It was Spencer Wagey just running right around him. But I will say this, at least one of Spencer's sacks – again, credit the crowd. O'Brien was 2 seconds late off the ball. Spencer had three steps in the ground before he ever even moved. You know, and I played defensive end in the Fargo Dome before, and I don't know how many sacks you want to credit to the crowd, but there was a number of them where you're keying the ball, the tackle is not, and they get off the ball late, and then it's just easy picking from there. So give them credit not just for the false starts, but for a couple of those sacks where the offensive line just slow off the ball.
Well, Coach Entz opened the postgame press conference by stating there were opportunities to win the game. He mentioned that, but he also acknowledged Bison Nation.
You said it right there. Five false starts and caused them problem. They had to change cadence to clap in the second half, and you know, Bison Nation did what we asked them to do.
That's always do what you ask them to do. Come up, make noise, definitely plays a role. I can say this, broadcasting for over a decade, and I've been part of a lot of games, a lot of high school games, a lot of college games. Not saying it because I'm sitting in this hot seat right now. Not saying it because I'm here in Fargo. Not saying it because, hey, I'm trying to, you know, be a people pleaser and please everybody up here because I'm the new guy. But the reality is I have never been part of a team or a program that the crowd makes that much of a difference. Everyone talks about it, but I have rarely seen it that game and that crowd made a difference in the first half.
Yeah, it absolutely did. And I even said it. I tweeted this out after the game. It's like, it makes me a better analyst. And I'm sure it makes you better play-by-play. Robin, you feel that energy. It's contagious. Everyone feels it throughout the entire stadium. The fans get into it more because, you know, the guy next to him is cheering and clapping and going crazy. And we saw the effect. I mean, it's not just, like I said, it's not just talk. It's not just like coaches talk or whatever. Like, oh, yeah, you know, fans, show up, make a difference, you know, just because you want to sell tickets. Like, no, they literally had an effect on that game, and that was the best crowd that I can remember. I mean, JMU was pretty good last year in the Dome at the playoffs, but it wasn't as full. This was the first time we've really seen what I like to call the Fargo Dome at full force, and that was – you know, and I'm happy these kids got to see it because we haven't seen it a ton lately. You know, there's been a couple games where it was a little bit lighter, but this is basically what I got to play in almost all the time, and it was awesome.
Yes, Micah.
Was this close to playoff loud in your experience? You know, or was it a little less than that?
Well, you know, it's tough. As much as I could feel it, it's tough when you have a headset on and you're up in the booth. But I would, you know, that might be a better, you know, question for your sideline guy and Cole Jerick, but I think – it had to have been close, right there, you know, and I think everyone felt the magnitude of this game, the first ever 1-2 in FCS in 30 years, the first time it ever happened in the Dome. As far as regular seasons go, I don't know how you get a bigger game. You know, both teams 5-1, their only loss is to an FBS school. Like, the crowd definitely understood the task at hand, and they came and they showed up.
Well, and you talk about the crowd and just what they do behind the scenes and making all and really it's not behind the scenes, it's part of the scene. Let's be honest. It's not behind the scenes. These guys are and ladies, everyone out there is part of that scene. Cam Miller starts out 12-for-12. I think Andy even said it, go back a game, 13-for-13, but starts out 12-for-12, finished up over 200 yards, 2 touchdowns on the day. Best performance by him by far this season. He continues to mold and get better. And we have a little bit about Coach talking about that as well.
He did a good job. And Cam's going to learn a ton from this game going forward. Excited that he's our quarterback and really look forward to getting back to work this next week.
You hear Coach say that, excited he's our quarterback. I can't think, if you're a Bison fan, how can you not be excited in Cam Miller? I know, look, football, you want to see the big plays. That's what everybody wants, to see the big plays. You want those big passes down the field. You want those big breakaway plays. That's what gets everybody on their feet, right? Everybody gets excited. But we know this brand of Bison football. The run game is first. The pass game comes second. Cam Miller is starting to develop that passing game, maybe in a way that we haven't seen this year. Guys like DJ Hart, where did he come from?
Right.
I called him the heartbeat of the wide receiver core now.
The wide receivers really came alive in that game, Rob. Especially, you know, I was about to say before that penalty, and I don't want to talk about the penalty, the one against Cam, but like, the, you know, Braylon Henderson got involved. DJ Hart got involved. Rajah Nelson was getting involved. Obviously, Zach Mathis has really come alive in the last couple of games. We saw what he did against Indiana State, and I think that was one of the frustrating things about the second half is, and, you know, and I think they made adjustments. I think they, without looking at it, I think just from a bird's eye view, like, I think they tightened up their coverage a little bit. I think they did a better job against the play action, and really what they took away was the run game. And then, you know, if you're not running the ball as well, that's not going to open up the play action. So that was the thing. Again, you look at the second half, they really came out and they made adjustments, and, you know, got to give them credit for that. But, yeah, Cam Miller, you know, this wasn't just a one-off thing in the first half. We've really seen it going back, you know, two games. This is 3 games in a row now where he really, really shined and played really well.
Look, and I know you said, hey, I don't want to talk about it, but we got to talk about it because it is kind of that – you know, the goose in the room,
the penalty.
Yeah. And it's tough. Tony texted us. He said, hey, Rob, that flag on Cam was a bad call. What do you think, Tony? I think I'm never going to put it on a kid. Never, ever. I will never do that as a play-by-play announcer for NDSU. I will never call out a kid. What I will say is you got to play discipline. You do have to play discipline. But I will also say let the kids play.
Yep.
Let the kids play. I've seen worse gestures out there. And there was other plays where guys were fired up after big plays and nothing was thrown. I saw a touchdown sign. I saw a first down sign. Let them have fun.
Horns down sign from SDSU pointing at the
flag.
Crowd. Like, I saw all this stuff going on, a lot of jawing, guys getting in each other's face. And like you said, Rob, there was nothing being called, and they were letting them play, and I'm fine with that. I think that's how that game should be played, unless it's something egregious. Like, keep the flag in the pocket. You know, looking at it on the review, like, live, I was like, okay, maybe he thought it was a throat slash, which you can't do, but it wasn't. You know, he's looking at the sideline, maybe that's the thing, but he's in the middle of the field, so it's not like he's right in someone's face, taunting them in the right, you know, right in their grill. Yeah, after, you know, just kind of digesting this game, like, I really didn't like that call at all. Like, you want, because it's a double-edged sword. Yeah, you could say Cam Miller, you know, you got to be smart in that situation. You can't do that. But, like, you want guys to play with energy. You need that. Like, you need guys celebrating. Like, we were coached to celebrate when I was playing at NDSU. Like, you need a guy that's the leader of your team to show that kind of emotion, to show that energy. And maybe it shouldn't have been done at that time, and maybe it should have been done in a different way. You can say whatever you want about that, but at the end of the day, like, that white hat, he's just got, you got to swallow your flag there. Just keep it in your pocket like that. You, and I know he, you never know what play is going to be the one that changes the game, but like, that's the one that changed it. You could point right there. After that penalty, nothing was the same.
Not that the ref maybe meant to show him up, but he threw the flag really high. He could have just dropped it right in front of it and then shook his head no. To Cam. It's like, does a ref normally do that after calling a penalty?
No. I mean, maybe every now. No, I guess no. Not that I can remember, because usually it's not something that happens after the play where the player's right in front of you. But
I don't want to accuse him of trying to show him up or be like the, oh, I'm the ref, I have the power, but I don't know. Just the look of that, giving him the head shake, like, and like kind of with a smirk, it didn't feel good.
Yeah, just let the kids play, man. Areas of concern in this ball game, obviously. There were some things that happened. We talked about the penalty. Coach Entz, he did talk about that second half.
I mean, they were still playing their quarters. I mean, a little bit of cover two late in the game, but I thought they tackled better, and you know, we just didn't execute when we had the opportunities to. I thought we did a decent job. Again, I'm just buzzing through these real quick. I thought we stayed ahead of the chains for the most part and got it into third manageables. I know we had some penalties that really shot ourselves in the foot at different times.
Those are the areas of concerns, penalties, and you know, and again, the red zone stuff, you got to work on that. And I'm not faulting Cole Payton. That was a tough break for him. We knew coming into this game, we said Tyler Roll's going to roll up something great. And you saw Cole come in, had a big run, an amazing run, but then under pressure threw that pick down in the end zone, and you hate to see that, and you feel for him. He's just trying to thread that needle a little bit too much in there by Cole, but I still like, look, if you're going to, you never want to lose against the Jackrabbits. I know this right away. From the moment I walked in this door, I was like, nope, you can feel the heat, man. To us younger guys, it's a rivalry. To the previous generation, many of you listening, you'll always say, hey, UND's the big rivalry. But to us, I mean, this is a rivalry that's starting to grow, especially over the last 18 years, moving up to that Division I level. But, yeah, Cole Payton comes in, and that one play does not define who he is.
No, and I've had a lot of people come up to me and ask me about that play, and, you know, the play calling was obviously questioned a ton after the game, and I understand that's, like, the favorite thing. That's the go-to for fans. You always got to question the play calling. But, you know, and I think Andy said this on the call-in show after the game, Bison Hotline, like, that's what fans have been asking for, right? Like, when are we going to run it with Cole Payton? Every time he comes in the game, we just run the ball. They know it. Like, they're keying on it. Like, we have to be able to switch it up. You have to throw the ball with him. And you could question maybe the timing of it. You can say, hey, you know, Cam Miller hadn't thrown an incompletion at that point. Why take the ball out of his hands? And I get all that, but like, I didn't hate the play call. It wasn't executed well. I'm not exactly what they showed. I don't know if they brought pressure or what, but they won along the line of scrimmage. They got heat on Cole, and that's just a situation where, as a coach, you just tell him, hey, it wasn't there. You just got to eat that, take the sack. And that, I know that's easier said than done, because look, this is a guy that he's been wanting this too. You know, it's not just the fans. Like, he's wanted to throw the ball as well, I'm sure, and he finally dialed it up. There's no way he's going down, right? He's going to throw it up and give his guy a chance. And I don't blame him. Like, he has pressure coming in from his right side. That safety is sitting right there in the middle or on the right side of the field as well, and he just floats one up. He never saw it. In his mind, he's probably thinking, okay, I got Hunter Lipke one-on-one. He's got a half-step advantage there. I'm just going to throw it up, and I'm going to give him a chance. And he just never saw the safety, and it just floated, and you know, and that was the result. So I understand questioning it. I understand the frustration with the turnover there, but like, that's what we've been wanting to see, right? And we finally got to see it. It just wasn't executed.
Yeah. And next time, guess what? You learn from it. And everybody said, look, well, how many games do you have to where you have to keep learning from it? Every game, you're going to learn from everything. Even a national championship, when you win, you're going to take things away and learn from it. If you're not learning, you're growing. If you ever get to a point where you feel like you've learned enough, then maybe it's time just to stop and go do something else, because you always have something to learn. And I understand. Look, let me step back as a fan also and say, I get it. After a certain point, you have to say, okay, guys, we've went through this enough and enough and enough. But this is a game that changes. It's a game full of different personalities. It's a game where young men are growing and developing. We're talking about 18 to 22-year-old kids. They're learning, they're growing, developing. And as we've seen in the years past, this does not mean the season's over. The goals still remain the same. Yeah, South Dakota State may have an easier path now to get that Missouri Valley Football Conference championship, but the season's not over. There's still a handful of games remaining, and that kind of leads me to my next kind of little talk here that we want to chat about is just how does this affect the Missouri Valley Football Conference standings?
Yeah, I was just looking at it. I mean, you know, in the Missouri Valley, you know, it's unique where if there's a tie, it's just a co-champion. So all you really need here is South Dakota State to lose one game. And I'd have to look. Now, they have it coming up. I don't know what they have after this, but coming up, they have a tough road trip to UND. We all know how well UND plays at home for whatever reason. Grand Forks, they are a tough team to beat. I believe they beat the Jackrabbits in that spring season at home. So you just need one loss there. Southern Illinois is also undefeated in the conference. NDSU sitting there at 3-1 with UND, and Illinois State also at 2-1. So still have a chance at the Missouri Valley Conference Football Championship. Obviously, now you need some help, which is tough, but that's kind of how it's shaken out, at least the way I see it right now, Rob.
Yeah, and the way that it finds out, you just mentioned at North Dakota, that taking place on the 22nd, a week later, hosting Indiana State. That should be a victory. And then on the 5th of November at UNI, and then to finish up the season, hosting Illinois State. And so, yeah, the road, looking outside of those teams, the most difficult task is going to be maybe UND. And you look at an Illinois State team, too, though, that's, you know, I don't want to say that this team is terrible. They're 4-2. They're looking pretty sharp this season.
Yeah, they've done some nice things. They had a nice win last week against USD. They played Southern Illinois really tough, and I think they have, I forget his name, but they have a couple difference makers on that along that defensive front. They have some really good defensive linemen, defensive players in general over there at Illinois State. And I think, you know, you can never overlook Northern Iowa either. I think Northern Iowa's tripped up SDSU a couple times. Now it's been at home for SDSU, but now they're on the road in the Unidome. I know maybe Northern Iowa's not the team that we thought they might be, you know, sitting there at 2-2 and 3-4 overall, but that's another game you can't overlook if you're the Jackrabbits. You can easily stumble. We've seen it before with the Bison. You can easily stumble against any team in the Valley.
Yeah, 100%. And you look, and my buddy Dave in Minot corrected me because on the broadcast I said, well, the path for North Dakota State is a little bit easy the rest of the season. It's not easy. That was me misspeaking. I'm gonna own it. Look, man, I'm learning the Valley. Down in the Valley. What's that old song?
Yeah, you're asking the wrong guy.
Down in the Valley. Valley so low, I lost my true lover for courting too slow. See, you can't court slow. You got to court fast. Michael's like, what are you even talking about, man? But here's the path, man. And I don't want to confuse you either over there, Kyle. You're like, what are you talking about?
I was trying to think of the song.
It's an old school. My grandpa used to play it, man.
I got you.
So for the Bison, here's where it's at. Illinois State after the bye, not the off week, the bye week. Then November 5th at Western Illinois. That should be a gimme. The 12th at Southern Illinois, and then you wrap up at home versus UND. So the road isn't easy. You got two tough schools in there, in Illinois State and North Dakota for sure, and you got to be on your A game, and I think the Bison will be able to take care of business. Just got to continue to work over this bye week, take care of business, learn from the mistakes, and move on, and I think that's what's going to happen. Well, hey, we got to take a break here in just a moment. Wanted to quickly go over our Jiffy Lube scoreboard, talk about some scores from around the Valley that we just saw here this past week. Indiana State losing on the road at Youngstown State, 48-42. We've seen Youngstown State. They've had moments of success, but still struggling in the conference, but still getting that victory. South Dakota was on the road at Illinois State. And boy, if you like Thursday night football, that was your Thursday night type of game there. 12-10 the score, Illinois State winning. It did not play on Thursday night, but you know where I'm alluding with that, how terrible pro Thursday night has been. Western Illinois on the road at Southern Illinois. Southern Illinois victorious there, 30-7. Jiffy Lube of Fargo has proudly served the Fargo-Moorhead community for over 40 years. You never need an appointment at any of their three locally owned and operated locations, so make your next stop at Jiffy Lube of Fargo today. That's Jiffy Lube of Fargo, where you can do more in a jiffy. We'll step aside, take a break. The Insiders continues when we come back.
Where the Bison roam. Bison 1660.
Rice Companies understands that strong buildings and strong communities start with strong connections. They know the importance of every bolt, every beam, and every handshake. Every connection must be strong. When you work with Rice Companies, you're building on more than concrete and steel. You're building on knowledge and expertise with people you can trust. People who value your investment as much as you do. Connect with Rice Companies, your local Butler builder, and experience the difference strong connections can make for your business. Learn more and see career opportunities at ricecompanies.com.
Bourbon lovers are a distinctive group, embracing the differences from other spirits, all while expecting the rich variation of a good whiskey. That's why the Fistful of Bourbon folks, who have over 100 years of whiskey blending experience, are born to serve to those lovers of good bourbon, creating the masterpiece of blending five distinct bourbon whiskeys, sweet, balanced, and floral, with notes of cinnamon and licorice and buttery toffee. Fistful of Bourbon delivers a smooth, rich, full-fisted flavor like all top-shelf bourbon whiskey should. See it all at fistfulofbourbon.com. Please consume Fistful of Bourbon responsibly.
The Fargo-Moorhead Diversion needs your help to transform our home into a safer and more successful place to live. When you join the ASN Constructors Fargo-Moorhead Area Diversion Channel team, you will take responsibility for creating a safety net for a quarter of a million people right here at home. Be part of history and the highest profile project in the FM area in years. ASN Constructors need dirt movers, heavy equipment operators, laborers, and construction apprentices. You'll earn great wages and benefits, including 401k. Apply now at ASNConstructors.com.
Sugar beet season is in full swing. Are you having issues with your bed liner while hauling? Contact Horn Plastics today. Horn Plastics has industry-leading bed liners that will guarantee you get every dime out of your haul. With a superior slide bed liner, you'll not only prolong the life of your equipment, you'll increase the amount of material in each load, increase the number of loads per day, which in turn makes you more money. Call today for a free estimate or to get your install scheduled online at hornplastics.com. That's hornplastics.com.
Here's your Red River Valley weather update on Bison 1660.
It's been a cold Monday with temperatures struggling to reach 40. Overnight, clear skies are expected with temps dropping to the mid-teens and winds blowing from the north at 6 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday will remain cold with highs near 40.
This weather update brought to you by Brady Service Center in Moorhead. Brady Service Center is your one-stop shop for all of your automotive needs, and with donuts, breakfast, and lunch items daily, they're also your one-stop shop for all your road trip needs.
Hi, it's Kelly, and I want to tell you about my great experience with Valley Service Mechanical. They were polite and very easy to deal with. They were knowledgeable and helped me understand every step of the process, from the initial discussion of purchase options to the installation. It was a top-notch experience. If you ever want to work with professionals, I would strongly recommend Valley Service Mechanical.
When your heating and cooling needs help and your plumbing is on the fritz, call Valley Service Mechanical, 701-293-5701. Online at valleyservice.net.
Take us with you wherever you go with the Bison 1660 app, powered by Thunder Seed, first in the field. Now, back to the insiders.
All right, back at it, friends. Having a good one here. Rob Hipp alongside Bison great Kyle Emanuel. Sometimes I hear the word like former Bison. You're never a former Bison.
That's right. Yeah,
once
thank
a Bison.
You. I appreciate that.
Always a Bison. And Micah Bendy, future Bison great, running the board for us today. Appreciate you, Micah, being back there as well. Let's head over to the Epic Companies hotline. As always, have our good friend Phil Hansen. And Phil, I heard you may be out of the country. What's going on? How you doing?
Yeah, we Bison bye week, so we thought we'd take a little vacation for a few days. And yeah.
Well, I hope I didn't. I hope I didn't interrupt you from any, you know, sipping back, relaxing, feet in the sand, margaritas.
Yeah, no, a little mimosa in the morning and margarita in the afternoon. Yeah, no, it was a good time to go.
Well, Phil, as always, good to have you on. Thanks for joining us here on the bye week. Hey, there's a lot to chew on from this ball game, and we could talk for hours about it, or we could talk for a few minutes. I would like to just talk for a few minutes on it like we always do, Phil, but there were some positives in this ball game. I always want to lead off with a positive note. Cam Miller continues to develop. We saw his passing game. Is that something that you've been happy with, just how that passing game is starting to become more effective?
Yeah, Cam's not a guy you talk about or worry about. I mean, the 15-yard penalty was pretty dumb, considering considering he's a quarterback, leader of the team. I mean, you don't even give the official the opportunity to throw a flag on you. That was really dumb. And you know what? Cam has been so consistent and he's really. Last couple of years, he's really made the occasion. You don't have to worry about him. You know what you're going to get with him. I think that was pretty positive. I think the big thing is right now is this team is not last year's team. It's not any of the teams that of the past 10 years. This is this year's team. And saying, oh yeah, we'll figure that out. Well, no, there's things that are becoming trends. We're over halfway through the season, and those are the things that have to be corrected. Everybody knows what they are. You got to either find better people, better personnel, or you got to find better schemes to match up, because FSU has just set the standard. Now they're on top. And that is the standard that you have to go after, and you have to find a way to get back to that level.
Hey, Phil, Kyle Emanuel here. Good to talk to you, and sorry for interrupting your vacation. But I just wanted to ask you, we had a caller call in and ask about the defense. Obviously, that's the side of the ball you played, and I gave my thoughts. I'm just curious your thoughts on the run defense and what have you seen there, and you know, how do you go about correcting that over this bye week?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the biggest thing that I think they can correct is the tackling. I mean, all that is wrapping up. You teach third graders, fourth graders, fifth graders, high schoolers, college kids, and pro kids how to tackle, and they still don't know how to tackle. If you watch tackling all the way across every level of football, it's atrocious. And NDSU this year has been very evident that it's not good enough. I know every coach says, you know, you got to wrap up, put your head across the bow, drive through the guy and get him on the ground. I just can't think of any coach would ever teach anything different. But like when players get out there in the game, they just lower a shoulder and don't wrap anything up and just play tough guy out there. Like, I'm going to knock this guy to the ground with my great athletic ability, and I'm going to drop a shoulder into him and he's going to go, oh, wow. Doesn't happen against good backs. Happens against some of them, but it certainly doesn't happen against good ones, and doesn't happen all the time. And I mean, it's very evident because it's really hurting the team on defense, and it's something that is just so easily correctable. That's why I start there. It is so simple to correct tackling. It doesn't take scheme. All it takes is a player deciding what I think is, in this case, lowering his manhood a little bit and just wrapping up and getting the guy on the ground. Somebody wants to really drop a shoulder to somebody, let the first guy wrap him up. You're there first, wrap him up. Let the next guy come in and try to, you know, dislodge the ball. I get all that. That's all good stuff. When it happens, it's great. When you get a loose ball floating around there and you got a chance to get on it, I get that. But you got to wrap the guy up first. That is just way too important, and it isn't happening. It reveals itself every week.
Phil, on that note, talking about tackling, I'm just curious, when you played, how much live tackling did you do in practice? I know there's been some talk about that, not just at NDSU. You know, I'm a Nebraska fan, and they talked about how they never tackled. And I understand, I'm on the side of, look, you can't do it all the time in practice, but I'm just curious, you know, how much did you do it when you played?
Yeah, NFL, I don't think we ever did. We certainly never tackled our guys.
Right.
You know, I suppose there's a bag or something you come in, but that's never the same. That's true. It's hard to replicate that. That's very true. But, you know, it'd be worth it to take a practice this bye week and just concentrate on it, go through every step of it again, and players would be laughing and saying, I know that. Well, you know what? If you know it, then do it. Do it on the field. Do it when it counts. And I did see some guys, I saw some guys coming up from their safety positions, actually, coming up and setting their feet. And, you know, you shuffle your feet a little bit, and then you go into the tackle. I did see a little of that, because I was looking really closely for it, because that's what needs to happen. And they made the tackle, and it was no big power hit or power trip or anything. You didn't blow up the guy, but you got him on the ground. I did see a little of it, but it just has to become way more consistent.
Phil, we talk about the bye week. I mean, does this come at a good time? I know it's always tough to go into a break after a loss, especially one like this, but is it a good time for this bye week to work on those things?
I don't like going into the bye week losing a game. That was always my thing, because you had to wait 2 weeks to correct it. But I don't think there's ever a bad time for a bye week, especially as I got older. You know, in the NFL, I always thought I could use a bye week between every week, actually. But, you know, I don't know if it's good or bad. Maybe it'll usually happen in September, but now, you know, maybe let's get some guys fresh and hopefully for the end of the season and a playoff push, it'll be good. But, you know, it's where I landed this year, and it is what it is.
One young man that I've been impressed with, I've already referred to him as kind of the heartbeat of this wide receiver core, is DJ Hart. 4 receptions, 59 yards, and a touchdown. What do you like from his play so far, and what have you seen from him?
Like everything I've seen, I just want to see more of it. Zach Mathis, too. You know, Zach Mathis caught a couple balls earlier in the year, and then he disappeared again, and then he was back later. And You know, he showed up in a big game. That's a big deal. To me, it is anyway. DJ Hart showed up in a big game, too. That's a big deal. Now just find a way to get them more into the passing realm of things and let them put a rip. They're both capable. That's got to give them great confidence, both those guys, you know, that they can do this and can do it consistently against good teams, because that was a good team they played on Saturday. And I just want to see more of it, both in the play-calling game, and they got to get open and bring the ball down. I really loved how Zach Mathis was really fighting for extra yards. I mean, he's a tall guy, goes up and gets the ball, possesses it, but then he turns around and does everything he can to try to push for some extra yards, and he's working at it. I like seeing that this last game.
Hey, Phil, I want to shift gears real quick. Let's go to the NFL. Let's go with your former team. Do you still keep up with the Bills? Are you a Bills fan? Obviously, they got a big win yesterday in Kansas City. Your thoughts on the Buffalo Bills and how they're playing right now?
You know, I didn't watch one play in the game. I just saw the score. I was traveling. So, but, yeah, I mean, I can only imagine after last year's game when Kansas City beat them that this was a little bit of retribution this year. So, they came back, but still, good game. They got a great team. I have watched them a few previous games. And, you know, once again, I just don't want them to peak too soon. Hopefully we're getting some guys back healthy and then getting ready for a nice playoff push for them as well.
All right, well, there he is, the Hall of Famer, Phil Hansen. Phil, as always, appreciate your time, even on this bye week with your feet in the sand and your early morning mimosas, my friend. Thanks for all you do and for chiming in with us.
Yes, very good, guys. Thank you.
All righty. Again, Phil Hansen there on the Epic Companies hotline. Always good to get his insight. And what I love about Phil, he'll tell it how it is. And he's earned that right, and he's been here a long time. And you know what? You get in front of Phil, you got to man up.
Well, yeah, and he's a guy at he's better at verbalizing it than I am. But like when you play at NDSU, like you understand the standard and you understand, you know, everything that goes into it, and you want to see that, you know, that production on the field. So I understand, you know, a little bit of the frustration, and I, you know, and that's just kind of what happens. That just comes with the territory when you've played at NDSU and you've given everything you have for this program. And look, I know these guys understand it. Like playing for the guys that came before you, that, you know, made this program what it is, that's a huge motivating factor. It's something that I know all these guys that they play for. And, you know, Phil will let them know if it's – he lets them know when it's good and he lets them know when it's bad.
And he's let me know, too, things I need to work on. So I appreciate that as I've learned to grow here as well. Well, friends, be sure to join us tomorrow for our weekly Sun Butter Easton Stick interview. Sun Butter, the maker of delicious sunflower butters that the whole family can enjoy. Sun Butter is free of the top 8 food allergens, including peanuts, tree nuts, soy, and dairy, grown in the tri-state area and produced locally at Red River Commodities in Fargo. That's Sun Butter, simple ingredients, delicious flavor. This hour of the Insiders is also brought to you by Rick Electric. When you need electrical work, you need our friends at Rick Electric. For over 56 years, Rick Electric has been providing excellent electrical service for homes and businesses. Visit them online at rickelectric.com. We'll take a break. We'll be back in a moment. The Insiders continues.
As the days get shorter and the temps get a little cooler, now is the time to start thinking about projects for Rick Electric in your home this fall. Hey, it's Chris Hansen. Rick Electric has been proudly providing services in the Fargo-Moorhead area since 1964. Right now's a great time to schedule your winter projects, like having a Generac whole house generator with automatic transfer switch installed, or more outlets for Christmas lights. Rick Electric, 233-6194, or go to rickelectric.com.
I'm Emily. I had my LASIK surgery here at Vance Thompson Vision. Being in the healthcare field, the highest technology is huge for patients. For me, that was the leading choice in why I chose to go with Vance Thompson Vision. Life without glasses in the operating room has been incredible for me. There's no more fogging. There's no more having issues with my glasses sliding down on my face. It's just been great for me.
Call 877-522-EYES to schedule a free consultation.
Steamatic. We all want to be part of a winning team, right? Hi, this is Marcus with Steamatic, and I am very proud of our team. Industry experts have voted Steamatic the best method of cleaning with our patented steam cleaning process, our 24-hour service, and highly trained technicians. We do it all from carpet cleaning, air duct cleaning, fire and water damage restoration, and remember, Bison fanatics choose Steamatic.
Steamatic.
If you're looking for a towing company that has graduated to the next level, you're looking for All Pro Towing. All Pro Towing specializes in heavy duty and light duty recovery. All Pro Towing is there for lockouts and jump starts and tire changes. Plus, they're available 24/7 for all emergencies. So when you're looking for a real pro, you need All Pro Towing. Save their number for when you need a tow. 701-541-3900.
A Road to the Ring is brought to you by Schmidt's Gems and Fine Jewelry. Bison Nation showed up in full force this past Saturday and helped create five first-half false starts by the South Dakota State Jackrabbits. However, second-ranked SDSU scored 16 unanswered points and held top-ranked North Dakota State to five first downs after halftime to claim a 23-21 conference victory at the Fargo Dome. Quarterback Cam Miller completed his first 13 passes and finished 17 for 22 for 227 yards through the air and two touchdowns. Wide receiver DJ Hart had a career day with four catches and 59 yards. The Bison are 3-1 in conference play and 5-2 overall. The Road to the Ring is brought to you by Schmidt's Gems and Fine Jewelry. They have a long history and reputation for quality workmanship and rock-solid pricing. Whether diamond engagement rings, custom jewelry, or repairs, let Brenda and the team at Schmidt's Gems and Fine Jewelry create a legacy for you and your family. The Bison have a week off before hosting Illinois State on October 29th.
The place you go for all your Bison news first. You've got the insiders right here on Bison 1660.
Back at it live from the Tharaldson Ethanol broadcast studio. Rob Hipp, Kyle Emanuel, Bison great. Future Bison great, Micah Bendy. That's his new tagline.
I technically already was a Bison. I graduated from NDSU, so
I guess.
I kind of was a Bison.
Yeah, I guess you can say if you went to school, it's not just about athletics. You went to school, so you can be great also. We'll call you great.
Thank you. Yeah. I wasn't so great in school. I was maybe like just above average.
Well, it got you here behind that board, which is great. So I'm glad you're here, man. No, in all seriousness, Micah does great work. We appreciate you, man. Hey, so look, before we digest a little bit more, speaking of digestion, good food, good things to eat, I want to talk about our good friends at Herd and Horns. Got to tell you, I went over there for the first time a couple of weeks ago. Loved it. Loved the atmosphere. You know, coming from an area that we had a prominent school, but there was no restaurant that was catered towards that university. Going into Herd and Horns, you feel like, man, is this thing ran by NDSU? That's how it feels. It's great. It's fun to be in there. Look, man, it's an NDSU-themed restaurant owned by alum. Therefore, that's why it feels like NDSU. 20-plus, 70-inch TVs. There's always a good view of whatever game you want to watch. 21 different beers on tap. Kyle Emanuel and I will go over there after the show. We'll try all 21. We'll let you know how we are tomorrow. We won't do that. We will not be on the show tomorrow if that happens.
I was getting ready to go.
All ages. This is what I love, too. We brought Braylon over there. She got a little food. She was having a good time. And, you know, some of the seats are a little bit higher. They have really high chairs. They've thought of everything. Herd and Horns. All ages. Doesn't matter if you're coming out with your buddies, your friends, your family. Herd and Horns, they can accommodate you well. Happy hour, 3 to 6 today. And through Thursday, Friday 3 to 5, $2 off all appetizers, $1 off all drinks. Go check them out. Our good friends at Herd and Horns. You will not be disappointed. That is what I'm digesting today. Hey, I wanted to tell you this. Phil came on, talked. One of the things that I talked about was the bye week. Kyle, he doesn't like the bye week being right now. I wanted your thoughts as a former player. Where do you like the bye week to sit? Or do you even want there to be a bye week?
Yeah, I mean, I think I'm trying to think. Sometimes, no. Actually, I take that back. You always want a bye week. Sometimes, like, if you're rolling and things are going well and you get into a routine and, you know, I think there's that at times where you could say, this is a bad time for the bye week. I think this could have came earlier. I think right where it was originally, where it has been throughout the schedule after the non-conference, because of, like we talked about, there's those certain things that just keep showing up every game. You know, we talked about a million times, tackling, penalty, whatever you want to talk about. Like, there's certain things that when you get to a bye week, you can really start to address those things. And that's the one thing NDSU hasn't had. You got to go right into game planning for that next opponent. Now they actually have some time. So, yeah, I think it's a good time. I think it could have came earlier, though.
I just had a thought while I'm dreaming. You know how people talk in their sleep? And I just had a thought of while I'm dreaming. Or maybe I'm not thinking of you dreaming, Kyle. I don't want to go down that path, okay? But I'm just thinking, while you're dreaming, penalties. Turnovers, penalties, tackling. That's what's happening. We just got to quit dreaming about that stuff.
Right.
It's in your head.
Stop talking about it. Right?
Stop talking about it. Friends, we're having a good one here today. First hour already wrapping up. We're a little bit afternoon. We're live from the Tharaldson Ethanol Broadcast Studio. It's our friends, Tharaldson Ethanol, one of the nation's leading largest ethanol facilities. This 175 million gallon per year ethanol plant located just west of Castleton. Fuel your future by joining the growing team. View open positions online at tharaldsonethanol.com. That'll wrap up the first hour. Hour number two coming up from the hot seat when we come back. Stay with us.
Looking to buy a new Ford in the months ahead? Then you should be checking out Muscatel Burns Ford. You'll enjoy Muscatel's stellar award-winning service. And be sure to ask about special finance terms and $500 order cash available now on select Bronco, Edge, and Explorer models. Muscatel's has a good selection of pre-owned models too. So stop in today. Muscatel Burns Ford, just 20 minutes from Moorhead on Highway 10 in Holly. Hey, get your next Ford from Ward.
Need storage? Mega Storage USA is here for you. Whether you need storage for your boat, camper, motorcycle, or even a food truck, they have the perfect unit for you. Contractors need a safe place to store your trailers and equipment or even a semi? Mega Storage USA has you covered. Each unit comes with 24-hour access, an electrical outlet, and light, plus top-notch customer service and more. Located off I-94 on the 29th Street interchange behind RDO and Moorhead. See all that Mega Storage USA has to offer at MegastorageFargoMoorhead.com or call 218-461-8158.
Here on Bison 1660, we love delivering the latest Bison news, but we also love our studio home.
Back inside our fantastic studio, you can't beat this one, folks. We love this place.
Now our home has a new name, the Tharaldson Ethanol Broadcast Center. Live shows and the latest coverage of NDSU athletics.
Director of Athletics Matt Larsen joining us. Head coach Matt Entz with us in studio.
It's all presented by Tharaldson Ethanol, helping North Dakota lead the energy revolution. Join their growing team by visiting tharaldsonethanol.com.
Hello, this is Matt Lehman and Mike Walski with Fargo Roofing and Siding.
We are here to help you with all of your commercial and residential roofing needs. Whether it's insurance-related repairs, remodeling, or new construction projects, our team is here to help.
We will approach every job with what we call Fargo values of honesty, integrity, accountability, and strong work ethic.
Schedule your free estimate today at fargoroofing.com. There is still time to get in this fall. That's fargoroofing.com. Fargo Roofing and
The most important aspect of any sport is teamwork. Someone to set up for the perfect play. In the real estate market, Todd Kattermas with Beyond Realty is the perfect teammate. He won't stop until your home is sold or you score big with your dream home. Call Todd Kattermas with Beyond Realty today at 701-371-4234 or visit him at Beyond Realty, 4832 Amber Valley Parkway in Fargo. Todd is a proud partner and the preferred realtor of NDSU Athletics. Todd Kattermas with Beyond Realty, moving the herd one home at a time.
Truck headquarters. Gateway Chevrolet has new Chevy trucks arriving daily. Buy your new Chevy Silverado at invoice. Yes, invoice pricing on new Silverados with a fresh look, new interiors, and larger screens with easy-to-use technology. Save thousands on new Chevy Silverados with four different motors available. Dynamic fuel management, Bluetooth, backup camera, Apple CarPlay, and more. Save thousands and enjoy the smooth ride in your new Chevy Silverado from Gateway Chevrolet. Find new roads. Details, gatewayfargo.com.
KQWB West Fargo, KPFX HD3 Kindred, and K224FD Fargo. Bison 1660, powered by Gateway Chevrolet, Cadillac, Nissan, and Hyundai in Fargo.
We are Bison Sports!
And here's what you need to know.
The Texans have made a change in their front office. Reports say Houston has fired Vice President of Football Operations Jack Easterby. Axios reports the Titans and Nashville Mayor John Cooper have reached the deal to build a new dome stadium for the team. It still needs to be approved by Nashville Metro Council. NFL Media says Chargers receiver Keenan Allen won't play tonight against the Broncos. For Denver, they are expected to activate all-pro safety Justin Simmons for the game. The Times-Picayune reports the Saints don't expect to have receivers Michael Thomas or Jarvis Landry against the Cardinals on Thursday night. They're optimistic Chris Olave will play. In the NBA, reports say Rockets guard Kevin Porter Jr. has agreed to a four-year, $82.5 million extension. And ESPN reports Trailblazers forward Nasir Little agreed to a two-year, $28 million extension. I'm Nick Cope.
You've got the insiders.
How you play today, from this moment on, is how you will be remembered.
That's what living is.
That's right.
There's 6 inches in front of your face.
Bringing you what you need to know and a whole lot more. Topics you care about, guests you know, and the conversations you came to hear. The Insiders are presented by ProSeed. Need seed? Think ProSeed.
This is your time. Now go out there and take it.
Now, here are the Insiders.
The Insiders.
The Insiders.
The Insiders.
Insiders.
Bison great Kyle Emanuel and the voice of the Bison, Rob Hipp.
Back at it, top of the hour, 7.5 minutes after, 12:07. Great day on a Monday. You're saying, Rob, why is it great? We lost.
It's chilly.
It's chilly. It's time for some chilly weather, chilly food, Frito pie and chili. You like Frito pie? A little sour cream, some onions thrown into that bad boy or not?
I think you lost me. I think that's a Texas thing.
Yeah, I'm
y'all
gone.
Don't do that here?
Nope. Don't even know what that is.
So you've
Frito
never,
pie?
You've never had Frito pie?
No, man.
Man, this is great. I'm glad I finally know some things you guys don't know.
Like
this is
maybe if you want to cook that up for us, I will gladly try it.
So you take chili, beans, the whole mix. You throw Fritos chips in it, some shredded cheese, sour cream. If you get a little bit dicey, throw a little guacamole in there.
Ooh.
If you want some salsa.
Sign me up, man. I'm in.
And then you want a little sour cream and onions. And then also make sure that you're up all night. You don't have anywhere to go the next day because it's not good for the stomach, but it is good, man.
Have you ever made this before?
Personally? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. I'm open to it. We got all week, man.
If you know about Frito pie out there, you call us and let us know on the Epic Company's hotline.
I can say
you can text us.
I've never heard of that.
Because it is epic. So
I'll have to ask my brother. My brother, he's a transplant, obviously, you know, grew up in Nebraska, but he lives in Texas now. So I'll have to ask him if he knows about that.
701.
Frito pie.
Yeah, that's right. 701-476-1660. Again, call or text us. Let us know your thoughts. What you got going on, too? And Matt Larsen going to be in here before too long. And if you'd like to chat with Matt as well, Director of Athletics, would love to have you on. That is the Epic Companies Hotline. Epic Companies, the area's premier real estate investing and development firm, online, epiccompaniesnd.com. Also, waving hello to everyone that is watching us on the Horse Cam. You can tune into the Insiders, streaming live on Facebook, courtesy of Horse. Horse, farming with passion, online at horse.com. Hey, wanted to talk very briefly, not to downplay them, not to put them out, because, hey, man, athletics across the board so important at NDSU. It's not just about football, even though football season's rolling. I did want to give women's soccer a little shout-out. 2-0 victory at North Dakota just a few days ago in Grand Forks. North Dakota State women's soccer team picking up that 2-0 victory over North Dakota Sunday afternoon, chilly Sunday afternoon, in the Summit League play there at Bronson Field. So congratulations to the lady. North Dakota State will close out the home schedule and the regular season next week by welcoming in South Dakota and South Dakota State on Friday and Sunday. Should be a little better weather, too. Temperature's going to be in the 60s over the weekend. The Bison will take on South Dakota in another key Summit League matchup on Thursday, October 21st. Kickoff there, 6 o'clock at Dakota Field. You can find out more at GoBison.com. Hey, I wanted to briefly go over some FBS scores, just briefly. What has been happening throughout the FBS? We saw some games, maybe some upsets, Alabama, Tennessee.
Some real good games.
Did you watch any of that?
I did not watch Alabama, Tennessee. No, I was watching. You know, a game I was watching all this awesome football going on when I got home. You just take a guess, Micah. You probably figured it out.
Turn on my own mic.
There you go.
Were you watching Fargo Shanley film?
No, I saved that for yesterday. I was watching Nebraska and Purdue.
Oh gosh,
just a barn burner.
Did they win?
No, they lost. So all these great games going on, and I was watching Nebraska lose to Purdue. So. That's what I was doing. But, I did pay attention. I thought there was a lot of – there's so many ranked matchups. This is probably the best weekend in college football. I don't even think it's questionable. It's the best weekend in college football so far. You had Utah upsetting USC, giving them the first loss. Michigan looked really impressive to me, and I don't know if I'm stealing this from you, Rob. I'm
no,
just
go
going
for
through.
It.
You know, Clemson had a nice win against Florida State. Jeff Cole Haynes, Florida State. I mean, but the Tennessee – you have to talk about Alabama, Tennessee. And it's not just so much – obviously, the game was great, you know, a shootout, 52-49, Tennessee. But it's more so what happened after the game to me. You know, I love when they storm the field, they tear down the goalposts. Like, if you don't see it very often anymore, usually if they think it's going to happen, they'll just kind of lay them down on their own so no one can take them. Not only did they take them down, I think they got them out of the stadium.
Or
both
of them.
Was that a rumor? Okay, so they actually get them out of the stadium, into the river, right?
So they were starting to take them down, like, the street downtown, like, outside of bars. and restaurants. And then...
Did they take him to the river?
After taking him to, like, bars outside and, like, everybody's partying with him, standing on top of the field goal post, then they took it to the river and then let it sink.
See, I love that. Now, I know there's some consequences to it. Don't get me wrong.
$100,000 fine.
I hope no one got hurt and things like that. But, like, that's the part of college football that's so awesome to me. And, yes, there was a $100,000 fine for Tennessee for allowing – they broke the SEC rule of letting fans out on the field after the game, which, you know, me and Mike were talking about this. How do you stop 100 – they had, like, 109,000 people. Like, how do you stop that, first of all? But I think Tennessee will be okay with that fine. They also started, like, a fundraiser to get new goalposts. Which I looked up. I was just curious. About 10 grand, maybe. Between 5 and 10 grand for a goalpost, something like that. So, you know, looking 20, 30 grand, maybe, if it's on the high end. Like, and they started a fundraiser for it.
There you go, man.
A lot of fun things came out of that game.
There's a video of Tennessee's president. There's a video of him watching the field goal post go down, and the fans are taking it. And then they're like, what do you think of that? He's like, we can do this every week. I don't care.
Absolutely.
Maybe after like 10 weeks, yeah, probably start to care a little bit because the SEC would probably start cracking down a little bit more. But, yeah, great victory there. Some of those scores, again, thanks for those updates. Brought to you by Jiffy Lube. Jiffy Lube of Fargo has proudly served the Fargo-Moorhead community for over 40 years. You never need an appointment at any of their three locally owned and operated locations. So make your next stop at Jiffy Lube of Fargo today. That's Jiffy Lube of Fargo, where you can do more in a jiffy. One final thing on that Tennessee-Alabama game. How about Jeremiah Crawford? I've never heard of anyone casually vomiting before, but he just looked over, casually vomited right there. It was on TV, threw up, and then shook his head at the Alabama defensive line and then went back to playing football. How about that, man? Have you ever seen that before, Kyle?
I actually have. I've seen linemen, you know, they get down their stance, they just kind of lean over a little bit, let it go, let it fly, and then they're back right back into it.
But he not only just let it go, but he also taunted him afterwards. Like, he shook his head at him.
Well, yeah, would you want to go up against a guy that just threw up all over himself?
No,
I wouldn't.
I think it's great.
Maybe it's a tactic, a strategy.
Where was the extracurricular flag on that, you know?
You can't
flag the guy for throwing up.
That's taunting.
It's taunting, man.
Puking, projectile puking, that needs to be a taunting flag.
Hey, that's a safety issue, man. You got germs and everything flying around now. Like, come on, that's got
Was my highlight of the day, to be honest. If I could think of like a highlight over the weekend outside of NDSU athletics, that was the highlight for me. Hey, can we get a little bit of music real quick? A little bit of music, Micah Bendy. There we go. Woo! What do you think about that one today?
Yeah, I like
it. It's time for a little stats perform. FCS top 25. We already knew the coaches poll number 4. We're not going to go down all of these, but we'll go down a few of them. South Dakota State, first time in program history. Now number 1, 6-1, up from number 2. Sacramento State holding the number 2 spot, moving up from number 5. Say holding, moving up 3 spots now to number 2. They're 6-0 undefeated. What have you seen from Sac, man? They've got a good program this year.
Yeah, well, they've always been that team for a while now, and they get it done in the regular season. But for me, it's got to be the postseason. Now, they have a tough schedule coming up, and I actually pull it up, Rob, real quick. They have Montana coming up, then Idaho, who just beat Montana, then Weber State, who, oh, by the way, is also undefeated. So, they're, you know, and I'll just get into it right now. Like, there's still a path, a legit path for NDSU. If you can win out, you're ranked number 4 in the poll. You got 2 big sky schools in front of you, and they got like that round robin thing going on there. Like, you got to imagine they're going to beat up on each other. Montana State's schedule is no cupcake either. Obviously, they got to play their rival too. So there's still a definite path for NDSU to that number 2 seat.
I think the poll, I'm looking at it right now, they goofed and put Montana State at number 3 and number 7. I think they meant Montana at number 7 now,
yeah,
dropping from number 3. So Montana State at number 3, 6-1. North Dakota State has dropped to number 4. Full season still ahead, guys. Keep that in mind. South Dakota State lost to him a couple of times, went on to win a national championship. Would rather have that trophy, no disrespect to the Dakota marker, we'd rather have the national championship trophy if it came down to it, 100%.
South Dakota State's trophy case is only a temporary thing because they only get the rock down there, so they might as well just display that because I don't think they have any national championships, so it's kind of like a temporary trophy case down them in Brookings.
I heard they ran out of steel. They built it out of aluminum, and it still holds up everything. Just kidding. Totally kidding. North Dakota State, number 4. How about Weber State? Number 5, they moved up from number 6. Holy Cross is now at number 6, moving up a 1 from number 7. And then Montana State, they dropped all the way down. Montana,
yep.
Montana dropped off. They wrote Montana State.
Yeah.
I'm on the official poll. They dropped all the way down Montana to number 7 from number 3. Incarnate Word stays tied at 8th, 6-1. That's kind of been a sleeper for us this year. Lindsey Scott Jr. continuing to be that guy. Jackson State, number 9. They dropped one. And then Chattanooga at number 10. That will wrap up your top 20. Well, what do we call it? Top 10. We didn't go through the rest of them.
You don't want to pull Andy Rickoff and do a top 15, even though it should be 10.
Yeah, Andy does a great job keeping up with his poll. So there you go. That's it. Hey, this hour of the Insiders is brought to you by Rick Electric. When you need electrical work, you need Rick Electric. For over 56 years, Rick Electric has been providing excellent electrical service for homes and businesses. Visit them online, rickelectric.com. Matt Larsen in studio. We'll have him when we come back. This is the Insiders.
This is the Insiders on your home for NDSU sports. Bison 1660.
So most companies claim they have good people, good product, good customer service, but the question is how often. We go the extra mile to take care of our dealers and our growers, and more importantly, their families and their customers.
ProSeed tries to bring a family-like experience. Farmers, we want to understand what their challenges are. We also want to bring products to them that help them overcome those challenges so that they can be as successful as possible.
Need seed? Think ProSeed. ProSeed.net, great seed at a reasonable price.
Talking about your farm finances shouldn't be intimidating. This is Scott Zalandic with Cornerstone Bank. We're a locally owned and managed community bank. We know the ins and outs of ag banking, and more importantly, we know what it means to be there for our customers. Find the right person to talk to you about your finances, someone you feel comfortable with, someone you trust for the advice and direction you need. Come to Cornerstone Bank.
Cornerstone Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
This guy had more issues with his eyes. The minute he first came out of surgery, he walked in with a huge grin on his face, and for the first time since he was a little kid, he could see perfect.
Going to Vance Thompson Vision was an easy experience. If you're gonna trust your eyes to anybody, trust them to a leader in that field.
When it came time for me to make a decision about where we were gonna go for my LASIK surgery, there was no question that it would be Vance Thompson Vision.
Call 877-522-EYES to schedule a free consultation.
Dakota Refrigeration has been helping the Bison succeed behind the scenes. From their training room to their dining room, from milk to medicine, from ice to ice cream, Dakota Refrigeration has been serving Minnesota, Montana, and the Dakotas for over 4 decades. Locally owned and operated since 1974, Dakota Refrigeration is a full-service source for your refrigeration, heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and electrical needs. Dakota Refrigeration, located in Fargo, Bismarck, and Minot.
Hey folks, don't let bad credit hold you back from buying a car. Corwin Public Wholesale can help you get financed today. Visit CorwinWholesale.com or stop by their location on 38th Street South in Fargo. Corwin Public Wholesale has helped thousands of people who have bad credit, no credit, bankruptcy, repo, divorce, or late payments. And with their financing power, Corwin Public Wholesale can get you into any vehicle today. They accept all credit applications. Apply today, drive today at Corwin Public Wholesale.
Here's your Red River Valley weather update on Bison 1660.
A sunny and cold Monday to start your new work week with highs only reaching in the mid to upper 30s. Overnight, look for clear skies that will allow temps to fall into the upper teens with wind gusts as high as 25 miles per hour. For weather anytime, visit Bison1660.com.
This weather update brought to you by Brady Service Center in Moorhead. Brady Service Center is your one-stop shop for all of your automotive needs, and with donuts, breakfast, and lunch items daily, they're also your one-stop shop for all your road trip needs.
Gearing up for another season of Bison football? We've got you covered each and every day on the Insiders on Bison 1660.
I feel glorious, glorious. Got a chance to start a game.
On their own 24-yard line, trailing 21-7, 2:18, shotgun snap. Gronowski goes down with a sack at the 15-line. There's a host of Bison. Spencer Wagey was the first one on him.
Just a host. It was a herd of Bison, but Wagey leading that charge there, picking up his sack. 4.5 sacks this season. Spencer Wagey doing great work. Welcome back in. 12:21 here on the Insiders. Thanks for joining us on a Monday, a chilly Monday, a Frito chili pie Monday. I'm going to educate these boys again a little bit more as we go on here today. But welcome back in. Matt Larsen joining us in studio. Before we get to Matt, I want to remind you, if you need to stock up on all your favorites for watching football, well, the Spirit Shop has you covered with their huge selection of beer, wine, or spirits at the best prices and great weekly specials. The Spirit Shop is off 13th behind Shill's Home and Hardware. Matt, it's been a while. Good to have you in studio, my friend. How you doing today?
No, it's good. It's always good to come in. Your first hosting responsibilities, I'm lucky enough to come in. So, no, it's always good to come in, get a little lunch, and get to hang out with Kyle today, too. So, even better.
Well, whenever I'm around, Matt, I love when you come in because I love a free lunch. I'm still that guy at 31 years old. Like, I still love a free lunch. So, of course, we appreciate you being here.
Yeah. We were talking earlier. Matt knew because he spent some time down in Texas, mm-hmm. director of athletics. But also down in Texas a little bit, knew all about the Frito pie, Matt.
Oh, it's a go-to. I think more states need to adopt it. I mean, it is. I mean, it should almost be the national food. It's now when I played Little League baseball, that was the go-to after the game. You'd go to the concession stand and you'd get a thing of Frito pie. Fantastic.
What'd you like in your Frito pie?
I was pretty simple. I had my Fritos, chili, and some cheese, and I was good to go.
Are you an onion guy?
Oh, I do love onions.
Okay,
yep, I do love onions.
I'm running in. You know, one thing I'm trying to discover, I'm still learning, and I know there's a lot of good places, but I'm looking for good barbecue around here, so I got to find some good barbecue because you mix it with onions, potato salad, mm-hmm. beans, the whole mix. We're getting hungry.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, that's right. Yeah, there's a couple here that I've actually been there. Piggy Barbecue is really good. There's also another one. Oh, where'd I go? It's like Terry's or something like that over right on Main Avenue. It's probably not Terry's. It's something else. But there's a couple spots here in town.
Great stuff. Well, Matt, appreciate you. Hey, you know me. You know how this program is. We always want to highlight the good things that are happening and start off with that. Tough contest a couple days ago. But we know that this game is always tough. It's always it's turned into that rivalry. You know, me coming here, that's mm-hmm. I saw it as a rivalry. A lot of people talk about UND, but over the past 18 years, this has been it's been one of those good ones. It always seems like it comes down to the wire. Just wanted to get your overall thoughts on the game.
Yeah, I mean, I think if you ask our players too, probably Kyle included, I mean, at SDSU from a football perspective, absolutely a game that's really important to us each year. And, you know, I'll start where James Kaser finished on Saturday. I mean, in terms of just unbelievable show out by Bison Nation. I mean, it was electric. I've been here. This is my ninth football season here, and that really seemed like one of the loudest times I've ever been in the Dome. And that's, you know, including a lot of playoff games, a lot of big games. But it was incredibly loud. So a huge shout out to Bison Nation. And, you know, I know folks are disappointed we didn't win. You know, but I look at it as those are the reasons why you come to NDSU. All eyes are on Fargo and the college football landscape and, you know, 1-2 and a great opportunity. And, you know, we came up short. And the one thing I know in my time here, you never let one game define the season. And, you know, we've been great at being able to do that. We're going to come in this week and we go into a bye week. We're going to make our corrections. But you can't let another game lose you the next game. And that's where we've been so good in terms of being able to make our adjustments. But you have to move forward. Nothing we can do now can change what happened on Saturday, right? You can only get better from it. And so I know that's, you know, our coach's goal, our player's goal this week is to get better, use the bye week to get healthy, use it to get better. And we still got a lot of season ahead of us. And that's the part that, you know, people forget we're 5-1 against the FCS still. It's you know, we're not staring down the barrel of 0-7 here. So I understand everybody wants to win every game. So do I. So does Coach N. So do all of our players. You know, but sometimes you don't, and it's how you respond from those things, I think, really defines what this team is going to be about as we move forward.
I think you hit the nail on the head, responding to adversity. That's what this team has done all season long, and we've seen it after Arizona. These kids have learned, and we've mentioned on the show earlier today, you know, you're 18 to 22 years old, and it's hard sometimes to learn to put things in the past and move on. But the coaching staff and everyone from the top down has done a great job teaching these kids, okay, put the bow on it. It's not the bow that we wanted, but put the bow on it. You know, it's a little bit of coal for Christmas. That's okay. Yeah. And then let's move on and move forward. And so we got the week to readjust, to refocus, to get gathered, and to move through. And I'm proud of this team and how they fight through that adversity. Mm-hmm. And you go back, and you're 100% right, Matt. You go back and look, the season, there's still a lot of games to be mm-hmm. played. I know I'm preparing for some of them. You know, the staff is doing, they're preparing way more than I am. I have the easy job. Mm-hmm. But you look at the future and this program, and you go back and you look at the past. And, yeah, you've lost against SDSU before, but guess what? Mm-hmm. You go on to win the national championship. There's still a lot to go, a long season ahead.
No, and I think that goes back to, you know, we just talked about it, is you can't have one game define what the ultimate end of the season is going to be. And, again, you learn from it and you get better. And that's what I've seen over the course of the 9 years, especially coming out of a bye week where we're able to refocus, readjust. And, you know, as much as you want to go back and change things, you can't. You can learn from them, though, and that's where I think Bison – football and Bison Athletics has done such a great job of using those life lessons, using the things that maybe don't go your way, to make sure it doesn't happen again. And so I know we'll be in that position this week.
Matt, another thing happened over the weekend, obviously Friday with the opening of the, see if I can get the name, Nodak Insurance Company Football Performance Complex.
Well done, Kyle. Wow. Well done. I didn't even. That's that NDSU education, you know, right there. Well done.
Prepare for that. I was just going to call it the indoor practice facility. So obviously that opened up. I want to just, you know, let you talk about your thoughts of that opening up and you know, the impact that'll make. And then also, you know, talk about, this was just the first phase, the second phase, and what's to come for that building.
Yeah, I mean, Friday was an incredible day, just for a lot of reasons. One is, it's been I said this to folks on Friday, it's been a journey. I mean, it really has. You think of, with these types of projects, you know, people think of, well, it's been under construction for 14 months, but this has been a 6.5-year journey in terms of when we first had the idea of, hey, we need something more permanent, to design, to feasibility, to fundraising, to all of those things that go into it. And there's so many people that were involved. So Friday, as much as it's great to open it up, and I know football did their walkthrough on Saturday, it's a celebration of all the people who had a huge part and a role in making it happen. And it all starts with our donors. You know, we're just so incredibly fortunate. We've done $110 million plus in athletic facility projects in the last 8 years, all privately funded. You know, if you don't have a passionate fan base, if you don't have people who care and believe in what you're trying to do, none of that's possible. And so Friday was a great way just a sincere thank you to the donors who got on early, on board, believed in the project, believed the impact it was going to have. And so that was a lot of fun. And obviously we got a chance to say thanks to them and get them to get around the facility. We met with some of our primary donors before the event and just said, you're going to be really proud of this facility. You know, what you had a hand in making is incredible, especially when you look across the college football or college athletics landscape, how it fits in with other facilities of this magnitude. And then you're right. The most exciting part for me is it's only half done. You know, we have the whole West Operations building that is underway as we speak and will open up sometime in April, May of this spring. You know, that's a huge other piece that I think folks don't realize how impactful that's going to be, from a new 10,000 square foot weight room to a new sports medicine athletic training space, more locker room space, meeting room space, a huge recruiting area that's going to allow us to recruit the next generation of Bison athletes here. So it's incredible. $53-54 million all said and done. That doesn't happen a lot at the FCS level. And so just incredibly fortunate to be in Fargo with such an unbelievable fan base, but it's going to be an incredible facility, and the impact it's going to have is incredible. It's awesome.
I got to ask, and I know obviously you weren't the architect, but you know, when the architects, you know, they go into the design phase of this, did they go look at other programs, go look at other FBS, you know, indoor practice facilities, or FCS, maybe one down the road, and be like, hey, we got to just do this or that. We got to make it a little bit better. Was that part of the design phase?
It was. I mean, I think anytime at NDSU, if we're going to do something, let's do it the best.
Yeah.
And there was no doubt about it. And so we had an idea, and conceptually, we had seen some, and again, I say we, you know, athletic staff, our football coaching staff, in terms of what were the amenities that we wanted to make sure were in there, in terms, because if you're going to do something, it's got to be more efficient, it's got to have all the things that you need to be successful. And so we had some general ideas, specifically with having the outdoor practice field right next to it, being able to open the doors, still have two full fields. And but what was really important when you go through this process is making sure you get an architect who's built these before, because their insight, you know, they've learned what to do, what not to do. They've seen a lot of these things. And so we relied a lot on really some of their expertise, and again, knew what we wanted in it, but where they said, hey, we've done this before, this might help you get to kind of what you're looking to do. And so we were really fortunate. So Foss here locally and Crawford Architects out of Kansas City were, I mean, just instrumental and phenomenal in getting us a facility that not only is going to show off really well, but it's going to serve us really well. And so we were really fortunate to get both of them on board.
World-class facilities, drawing in amazing talent, great student athletes on the athletic side, the academic side, NDSU doing everything with excellence. And I've talked to you about that, Matt, and just appreciate all the great work that you and your staff do. Did want to go real quick. We got to get a highlight in.
Okay.
Let's talk a little bit. We saw a great play, one pass, 30 yards, touchdown, Hunter Lipke. It was a great opportunity there for the Bison. Lipke doing some big things on the receiving end in that game.
Miller stands in the gun all by himself on the left hash mark at the 35, four up front. Miller steps up, now passes, wide open, Lipke, touchdown! Cam Miller started to look like he was going to run. Pulled back, Lipke was wide open right up the middle with the pass and a touchdown strike. Adding more insurance here, now the lead 20-7.
That was your JGP Electric highlight of the game. When it comes to your electrical needs, you only need one call, and that's to JGP Electric. They're professionals that can follow a strict timeline and get your project done when it's needed. Call them today, 232-1991. Call today, again, 232-1991 to experience the JGP difference. The Insiders is brought to you by Proceed. Need seed? Think Proceed online at proceed.net. We'll step aside. We'll take a break. More with Matt Larsen when we come back on The Insiders.
You've got The Insiders on your Bison Nation station, Bison 1660.
Your brilliant proposal starts with Schmidt's Gems and Fine Jewelry, your source for mined and certified lab-grown diamonds. Looking to create a custom engagement ring? Our team of jewelry experts will help you create that perfect ring, mesmerizing her, creating an heirloom to be cherished for a lifetime. Schmidt's Gems and Fine Jewelry, 3241 42nd Street South, Fargo, online at schmidtsjewelry.com.
It's that time of year again. Our kids are busy with activities, and we're all running in different directions. So, stop. Take a few minutes and look around your home. Seriously, look around your home. Does it feel comfy, not chaotic? And your kitchen, is it inviting, organized, and clean? If not, do what I did. I got help from Northern Stone. They understand that a new quartz or granite counter and backsplash will refresh and change the look and feel of your whole kitchen. Northern Stone, visit Main Avenue in Fargo across from the fairgrounds.
Jeremy here at Horsch in Mapleton. Did you know that Horsch manufactures premier planting, seeding, and tillage solutions right here in the FM area? We are proud to be a family-owned business based out of Germany and would love for you to join our team right here in Mapleton. We offer competitive pay, full benefits, and paid family time from Christmas to New Year's. Please visit Horsch.com to view our current openings.
Tired of your real estate goals getting blocked? Let Todd Kattermiss with Beyond Realty serve up your next big move in real estate. Todd's expertise in the Fargo-Moorhead area means he's the one to line up the perfect shot. Call Todd Kattermiss with Beyond Realty today at 701-371-4234 or visit him at Beyond Realty, 4832 Amber Valley Parkway in Fargo. Todd is a proud partner and the preferred realtor of NDSU Athletics. Todd Kattermiss with Beyond Realty, moving the herd one home at a time.
Are you ready for game time? Football and Fireball is a match made in heaven. And by heaven, of course, we mean Twin Peaks. Spice things up next game day with a shot of their favorite cinnamon whiskey. But first, kick off your game day with brunch. Get a good base to cheer on your favorite team. Brunch is now being served at your local Twin Peaks. Wake up with the scratch favorites you love and classic brunch drinks that won't break the bank. Contact Twin Peaks for availability and more details. Twin Peaks, eats, drinks, scenic views.
If you're looking for a towing company that has graduated to the next level, you're looking for All Pro Towing. All Pro Towing specializes in heavy duty and light duty recovery. All Pro Towing is there for lockouts and jump starts and tire changes. Plus, they're available 24/7 for all emergencies. So when you're looking for a real pro, you need All Pro Towing. Save their number for when you need a tow. 701-541-3900.
Whether it's the FCS, NFL, or productivity at work, we have you covered.
That man is playing Galaga. Thought we wouldn't notice, but we did.
It's The Insiders on Bison 1660.
Gonna have to bring Galaga in here for Micah Bendy. Get him on that. Bring back some old school gaming. You never played that, have you, Micah?
Is that the one where your spaceship is on the bottom of the screen and you're shooting upwards?
Old school, man. Go back to the Atari 2600 mm-hmm. days. Mm-hmm. It's Matt and I. We're talking the same language. Yeah.
You'd
good
be,
stuff.
You'd be surprised. I played Tecmo Bowl.
It means we're old.
Oh, that was
a
great game. Super Nintendo?
Yeah, Tecmo Bowl was
fun. That was a great game.
I went out, you know, this was a couple months ago. Bridget and I went out one evening, and I was sitting down enjoying a nice beverage. And I looked across, and I was like, I'm starting to become that guy that nobody wants to talk to anymore. And here it is. So, anyways, hey, we're back live at it. Having a lot of fun here on The Insiders. Thanks for joining us. We are live from the Tharaldson Ethanol broadcast studio. Tharaldson Ethanol in Castleton is open for corn receiving now through Friday for wet and dry corn, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. You can contact our good friends Brad or Doug at Tharaldson Ethanol or visit cmgtharaldsonethanol.com for more information. Matt, as always, such a joy to have you in here talking NDSU athletics, talking great things. We talked about the Nodak Insurance Company Football Performance Complex. I want to go back just to a little bit to this season. Seven games already in the books. Do you ever feel like things just, do they ever seem like they slow down, or is it once you go, you go?
I think it is a little bit of that, especially, you know, people always ask you, you know, when's the downtime in college athletics? And I don't know if there really ever is a downtime. I would say maybe in the summer, you know, maybe you're more 9 to 5 Monday through Friday. There's still some weekend stuff and there's some night events depending. But you know, once we get to once the season starts and the school year starts, I mean, it's usually 7 days a week from August, September-ish to probably May, June. And, you know, I think there's some people that are like, wow, that's crazy. But you know, if you love it, you enjoy it, it's certainly a lot of fun. The fall semester always seems to go a lot quicker for me, just when you're at a place that has football, just because there's so much lead up and prep into each and every game, administratively, coaching, student athlete, whatever it might be. And so, yeah, you blink. I mean, it feels like we just kicked off the season a couple of days ago against Drake, and here we are. We're heading into our bye week with week 8 essentially coming up next week. So it's just crazy how fast the fall season always seems to go.
Bridget and I were talking the other night, and I said, sweetheart, it feels like we're still in that U-Haul.
Yeah.
Two dogs in the car to U-Haul, but here we are, and it's 2 months in, and now football halfway through, mm-hmm. and you start talking basketball, and yeah. soccer's going yeah. on right now, yeah. and they're doing, and congratulations to the women, they're doing well. Volleyball's doing mm-hmm. very well. Yeah. Wanted to give you an opportunity, this, and I've told you this in person, haven't told you on the insider, it's obviously my first time to talk to you here on this yeah. show, but when I came in for the interview, the one thing that stood out to me was just the excellence this program has, mm-hmm. and I've talked to you about it, and I've mentioned on other interviews, but it's not just for football.
Right.
It's for all 13 sports across the landscape at NDSU. That it's all about winning championships. Yeah, you want to win national championships, but let's win championships first, then we can think about the big picture in the national championships. Just wanted to give you just an opportunity to talk about that and why that's so important, because some schools do, and I'm not putting anyone down, but some schools do put such a heavy focus on football that it's mm-hmm. some of those other programs kind of feel left out. That's not yeah. the case here at NDSU.
No, and I honestly give credit. I mean, that goes back a long, long time. I would say way before Matt Larsen got here, and my hope is it happens way after I leave and dead and gone or whatever it might be. And there's always been an emphasis of, if we're going to sponsor the sport, we want to be competitive and we want to try to compete for championships, period, end of discussion. So whether that's how we fund our staffing, whether that's how we fund their operating budgets, whether that's you look at the facility impacts we've had, every single program has benefited from that $110 million we talked about, whether it's upgraded practice facility, game facility, locker room space, training room space, you name it, we've upgraded their areas. And so office space for our coaches. And so there is absolutely that commitment. And it's not just something we have administratively. I think that absolutely spills over to our fan base, to our donor base. They understand, yeah, football drives the boat in a lot of ways. But shoot, we want to win in everything. And that's what we tell recruits. I always tell them, when you come to NDSU, what you do here matters. You know, there's a lot of places where you win games, you lose games. People don't care. Here they care. They care a lot. There's incredibly high expectations. And so that's where our coaches do a really good job of identifying young men and women at the high school level that can handle that, because there are high expectations. There's a lot of pressure to be successful here. And so finding the right student athlete that understands that, understands that there's going to be adversity, understands that you may have been an all-world high school kid. There's a development and a learning process here, regardless of the sport. And, you know, you may not come in and play right away. And can you handle that? And so that's where we've been incredibly fortunate, is the people in the locker room at the end of the day. And I told the donors on Friday when we did the practice facility, I said, you know, we love winning, we love competing for championships, but I think we do it the right way and with the right kind of people. You can go up and down all of our rosters. There's not a kid that I say, you know what, I wouldn't bring that kid home to my family. You know, and that's not the case at everywhere, you know, but just in terms of character, hard work, ethics, all of those things, we're doing it really right from that standpoint. And I think that stuff translates to success on the field, on the court, on the track, in the classroom, all of those things translate.
Matt, I wanted to talk to you. There was some other news last week. Obviously, another FCS school going to the FBS, Kennesaw State, joining mm-hmm. the Conference USA. And I think, you know, I had to ask you about it just because I feel like, you know, Bison fans, they continue to see these FCS teams jump up, and they're like, well, why can't that be us? Obviously, it's not that simple, but I just want to get your thoughts on them jumping up and, you know, why maybe it's not as easy for NDSU just to make that jump like that.
Well, I think there's a lot of moving parts to it, and I think our fan base understands it at some level, but I do think they see, well, hey, we've had all this success. Why haven't we had multiple right. offers? And there's just a lot of things that go into it. And, you know, Conference USA announced that they're going to add Kennesaw State, and if you look at geographically, they stretch from Texas to Florida now. I don't think our fan base would want to be in a league that stretches from Texas to Florida. And so, again, it has to – all those things have to make sense. And in this case, for Kennesaw State, probably made sense. You know, they have 43-plus thousand students. They're outside of Atlanta. Conference USA sees that as they're trying to tighten their geography a little bit, even though they spread all the way across the south to the southeast, trying to tighten that a little bit. And so – you know, it doesn't always come down to the level of success you've had on the field, how long you've been in Division I. I mean, again, it's not too long ago. You go back, Kennesaw State was just transitioning to Division I. And so sometimes it has to do with location. And again, as I've told everybody, we would never make a decision just to make a decision. It has to make sense. And that's in a lot of areas, whether it's building facilities, whether it's hiring coaches, whether it's, you know, conference alignment or whatever it is, we're going to be really thoughtful with how we do things, because it's not a decisions aren't about tomorrow. It's about the next 50 years and making sure that if we do anything, we're making the right decision for NDSU and for the next 50 years, not the next 5 years.
Those are all good points. You think about a municipality in a city, when they think about how are they going to bring water to a city, well, they think the 50-year plan. You always hear in a city the 50 or 30-year plan, and you go forward. We were talking kind of in that break, and definitely not to put down or downplay any other program or any school, but do you feel that maybe there's pressure on some locations to move up to that FBS level just because of the ever-changing landscape of college football with how we see things moving?
I think a little bit. I mean, you just look at the FCS level. I mean, the last 4 or 5 years, there's been a lot of movement. And, you know, in both directions, there's been movement from the top level of FCS or mid-level of FCS up to FBS, and then you've had a huge movement from Division II, kind of backfilling, you know, some of those programs as they've elevated, as programs who have been who've been targeted. They're trying to fill up their membership and keep their conference alive, and so they're looking to Division II. And so, you know, I think if you're looking across that landscape, you know, when you probably got into FCS, however many years ago, it looks a lot different. And I think people are trying to decide, is that where we still want to be long term? Or are there better opportunities being with more like institutions down the road, and what do those options look like? And so I think that's where everybody's looking at. We've talked on this show before about transformation committee and where the NCAA is going, and, you know, quite frankly, there's still a lot of unknowns in terms of what's it mean to be a Division I? What are the requirements going to be? What's the additional cost to be a Division I institution? And so I caution some of these programs that are making these decisions without having all the information, because, you know, you hate to see somebody have buyer's remorse down the road, and all of a sudden you're an FBS program, and, hey, by the way, it's going to cost you this much to do it. Well, shoot, we just transitioned. We got to figure this out now. So, again, a lot of moving parts, and everybody has to make the right decision on their campus that they think at the right time. And, you know, that's certainly the things that we look into when we make decisions.
I can say it just from a guy on the outside looking in, and not just saying it, Matt, because you're sitting right in front of me, but – I can speak of that excellence that I've seen as someone from another state, 1,200 miles away, and just to the fan base to encourage them and let them know everything that from what I've seen and what numerous others have seen has done with excellence. And when that time comes, the time will come. Until then, let's keep competing and kicking butt. That's really what it comes down to for me, Matt. So, well, you know, I want to talk to you mentioned the Nodak Insurance Company Football Performance Complex.
It's a mouthful.
I was getting there. You know, it's a lot, but it's worth it. Every single letter that's in that is absolutely worth it. Future projects. I mean, I was talking to Scott Walken last week. What's in the pipeline?
Yeah. You know, I'm trying to get people to get, hey, let's just call it the Nodak, right? I mean, it's nice and simple. It ties in all of those things. Obviously, Nodak will appreciate it, but no, I mean, we like I said, we've been really fortunate, and I always go back to, too, when, you know, when I first got here, everybody's like, oh, we need to be in the Big Ten. I was like, well, have you seen our facilities? Have you seen some of our infrastructure and those things? And so I think we've come a long way with a lot of those things and the way we support our student athletes, some of the infrastructure, some of the facilities, and so have accomplished a lot. But I think you're always looking at what's next. You know, right now we're in the process of doing some upgrades to Dakota Field, which is now the permanent home for women's soccer. Football no longer needs to practice there, and so we're doing some upgrades and renovations to that facility to make it more home for them. You know, that'll span over the course of this next year or so. We did some things this summer. We'll do some things in the fall and next summer to upgrade that. We're looking at an indoor hitting facility out at Thurlton Park for softball and baseball to be able to use year-round. As great as the Nodak's going to be for them, they'll be able to do a lot of stuff in there. But just having a place where they can go in and, you know, get some cuts, take some grounders, those kinds of things is going to help them with their, you know, kind of year-round development. And then, honestly, I think the last program, you know, that we want to look to try to help out a little bit from a facility standpoint, just from a footprint, is probably wrestling. You know, when we renovated the the Bison Sports Arena now into the Shield Center and the Sanford Health Athletic Complex, you know, their footprint kind of stayed the same in terms of practice space. And so maybe looking to do some things to just give them a little more room to spread out and to be able to train at a high level that they need to, given the league that they're in and what they have to compete against on an annual basis. So I think those are some of the things probably coming down the road as we look at what's next. And then final and probably most importantly is would love to see a renovation to the Fargo Dome. You know, I mean, it's been an unbelievable facility for Bison football and Bison athletics and our community, quite frankly. I mean, it has served our community so well for 30 years. But as with anything else, you need to stay cutting edge. You need to continue to improve those places. And so I know there's conversations there, but they certainly have our full support of moving forward with that.
A lot of great things in the pipeline. Stay tuned, and you can always follow it at GoBison.com. As it happens, you'll be able to read it there. Well, the show today brought to you by Dakota Bank. Dakota Bank, one of the largest ag banks by volume and the top ag lender in the Dakotas. They are committed to the producers, and families that make our communities great. Visit their new Fargo location and find out how their team is here for you. Go with commitment, experience, and integrity. That's Dakota Bank. We'll step aside. We'll take a break. I believe our final segment. When we come back, stay with us. This is The Insiders.
A sports talk station that Bison Nation deserves. Bison 1660.
Dakota Bank is one of the largest ag banks by volume in the United States, and certainly the top ag lender in the Dakotas. For decades, Dakota Bank has worked with ag producers just like you. We're committed to the producers and families that make our communities great. I'm Judd Graham, market president of our new Fargo, North Dakota location, and my team is here for you. Go with commitment, experience, and integrity. Dakota Bank, banking, insurance, mortgage, and trust.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC. Trust and insurance are not FDIC insured.
Location. If you are a business owner looking for your next commercial space, Epic Companies has the best options for you. Whether you are looking for 1,000 square feet of commercial space or 50,000, Epic Companies has what you're looking for. We have properties in West Fargo, South Fargo, Downtown Fargo, and Moorhead. Move-in incentives are currently available for a number of our properties and can be discussed with Zach, our Director of Realty. Visit EpicCompaniesND.com for more information. That's EpicCompaniesND.com.
As the days get shorter and the temps get a little cooler, now is the time to start thinking about projects for Rick Electric in your home this fall. Hey, it's Chris Hansen. Rick Electric has been proudly providing services in the Fargo-Moorhead area since 1964. Right now's a great time to schedule your winter projects, like having a Generac whole house generator with automatic transfer switch installed, or more outlets for Christmas lights. Rick Electric, 233-6194, or go to rickelectric.com.
This is Menley from Healing with Hyperbarics, and I want to talk to you today about how hyperbaric oxygen can help you if you've had radiation in the past. Radiation saves lives by killing cancer cells, but the damaging effects of radiation to the tissues continues. This leads to poor blood flow in these tissues, causing a range of problems depending on which tissues are radiated. If you've had radiation in the past and struggle with any post-radiation injuries, book an appointment with us at Healing with Hyperbarics to see how hyperbaric oxygen can help you heal.
He's back to pass. The blitz comes, but he stays ice cold and throws a fireball over the middle to Johnny Walker. That's a touchdown. That's why he's the captain. And now he's doing that touchdown dance he rehearsed all week with his teammate, Jim Beam. I'll tell you what, that's the kind of spirit you have to go to the spirit shop for. We've got that spirit at the Spirit Shop, just off 13th Avenue South behind Shields Home and Hardware in Fargo.
Farmers, Tharaldson Ethanol is open for corn receiving now through Friday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. for wet and dry corn. That's now through Friday from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. for wet and dry corn. Tharaldson Ethanol is located at 3549 153rd Avenue Southeast in Castleton. For more information, contact Brad or Doug at 701-347-3321 or visit Tharaldson Ethanol online at cmgtharaldsonethanol.com. That's cmgtharaldsonethanol.com.
Here for you for all the Bison football coverage you can handle.
These guys do an unbelievable job, and you want to know what's going on in Bison sports, you know, tune in to The Insiders.
The Insiders on Bison 1660 and 92.7 FM.
Back at it, final segment on The Insiders. Rob Hipp alongside Bison great Kyle Emanuel. Newest Bison great Micah Bendy. He said earlier, I kept saying future Bison great. He's like, I went to school there, so we're going to go ahead and say yes. Bison great Micah Bendy.
Bison above average, Mike Evindy.
Okay, above average, all right. And NDSU GOAT, Matt Larsen in the house. Matt's humble. He won't take that title, though.
No, we got a lot of those in our history, that's for sure. I ain't one of them.
What do you call Cole, Jurek? Is he a former Bison great, too? Because I don't think so. I think you got to knock him down a peg, like former Bison.
Contributor.
Like, pretty solid player, but not great. Because if you're calling him great, then you just water it down too much, you know?
So. Well, I'll say Bison great sideline reporter,
yeah.
Cole Jurek.
There you go. There you go.
Yeah. It's been a fun one here today. Hey, I want to remind you, Men's Hair Co. It's the only place to go for haircuts, waxing, shaves, beard care, and more. You can find a location near you with 5 Fargo, Moorhead, and West Fargo locations to choose from. Go with the home team for your haircuts this football season. It's Men's Hair Company online at menshairco.com. No, I didn't have time to get into too much pro stuff. There's a lot of professional sports, obviously, going on. NFL, MLB, Commanders over the Bears, 12-7, slugfest. Not a fun one to watch. Matt, are you a fan of Thursday night football?
Boy, well, this year, no. This year, I mean, there's been some bad games. The reason why I like Thursday night football is just because, and my wife hates this, but once you get into the swing of the season, I mean, you can basically watch football, college or pro, just almost 7 days a week. And so I love that part of it. She, like I said, not so much. You know, once you get into, you know, the full swing of action and all those things, shoot. Outside of Tuesday night, I think that's the only night you probably
Tuesday's action, isn't it?
Is that though? It's Wednesday. Maybe sometimes it is Tuesday.
I think Wednesday's the only day. Micah probably knows.
So I think you're pretty covered there. So
I think Wednesday's the only day where there's not football.
Yeah.
But and I could concur. I feel you there, Matt, because my newly married, my wife, hey, you're watching football again? Yeah. I was like, well, you know, the Bison game doesn't count. I'm not really watching. You know, I'm working.
I'm working.
So now I got to get home and I got to just relax. And I watch the game and then it's Sunday. And so I feel you there.
Well, and of course, this year too. The last couple of years, what doesn't help is so I'm on the FCS committee, so I'm now watching more games. You know, on my downtime, I'm pulling up the stream of whoever played that last week. You know, games that are going to have an impact on top 25 and all those things. So yeah, she's kind of footballed out, and we still got a long way to go.
Vikings. 15 yards through the first 25 minutes, I believe, yesterday. Defeat the Dolphins. Dolphins, of course, we know the troubles that they've had at the quarterback position. Can't speak today. Teddy comes back in, right?
Teddy Two Gloves.
That's right, yeah.
Teddy Two Gloves comes in. Mm-hmm.
Against his former team.
Against the former team. Can't hold on. 24-16, Vikings victorious there. Matt, are you a Vikings fan?
You know, I'm not. I am actually a formerly Redskins Commander fan, and that goes way back to when I lived in North Carolina like 1,000 years ago. So I've always kind of been a Redskins fan. I'm still struggling with the Commander thing, and I know that's probably not politically correct, but I'm, you know, old habits die hard, right? So, being out here, you know, I'll follow the Twins. I'm a Yankee fan, and I'm not even going to talk about Saturday night because after it was a long day Saturday. You know, obviously we had a tough one against in the marker game, and then I go home and Yanks are winning. This is great. 5-3 in the bottom of the ninth, they blow it, and thank God they bounced back yesterday and won. But I like watching kind of the local flavor, and so you know I'll watch you get a lot of the Vikings games, so I'll watch them, I'll follow them, you root for them, and then obviously the Twins organization has been so good to Bison Athletics and our football program in particular. So, you know, always watch them and rooting for those guys.
You know, Matt, I don't think you were alone there with a couple of Bison fans that, you know, they were obviously upset about what happened in the marker game, and they were Yankees fans. And I think it just set a couple of them off. I think maybe a few of them might have called into the show after. I mean, there was some angry people, and I don't think it was all just NDSU fans. So I don't think you're alone there. Hey, but Rob, I want to say, you know, we're talking about overreaction, meat sandwich. I know you don't like the meat sandwich. But like, is this an overreaction to say the Vikings are the second best team in the NFC?
No.
Is that an overreaction? I don't think so. I mean, Eagles, so I'll give you Eagles. The Bucks haven't looked great. The Packers haven't looked great. Who else would you put there in front of them? Cowboys just lost.
Yeah, don't talk to me about that.
Yeah.
You know? But, well, I mean, look, we're already in, you know, 5-6 games into the season. It's time to start separating. It's time to start separating the sheep from the herd now.
And the Vikings' only loss is to the Eagles. Now, you could say, well, they're not really beating anyone convincingly. I will go talk about positivity. I'll go the other route. They're finding a way to win games. In the NFL, that's what it's all about. There's so many one-score games in the NFL. If you can just have that mentality, like, doesn't matter, it's close at the end of the game. Like, we just have that mentality of something's going to go right and we're going to find a way to win. Like, that goes a long way. And so for all you Vikings fans out there, I won't insult your intelligence and try to like break everything down because I don't watch them every week. But I will say, hey, man, Kevin O'Connell, like they find ways to win games.
Hey, wait, how about the New York Football Giants?
Yeah, I mean, well, we talked about
now
them
again.
Already, yep.
I don't know if I'm quite a believer yet. I mean, and they've had their struggles, but you know, you talk about finding ways to win games. And so when we were actually in Indiana State, Jerry Rosberg, Bison great, inducted into the Hall of Fame, and you know, he always tell you that same thing. We got to see Gus Bradley down in Indiana State, and they had just come off a Thursday night win, you know, in Indianapolis. And he said, shoot, he said, you win a game in the NFL, I don't care how you do it. I don't care how ugly it is, how pretty it is. It's a win, and you take every single one you can get. So it's all about scrapping, you know, putting together games. Now I would say the NFC in general is probably way, way down. But, hey, you can only play who's on your schedule. And so for the Vikings, they keep winning. They're going to be right there in the end.
Al Davis with the Raiders said it best, just win, baby.
Yeah.
Just win. Well, hey, speaking of winning, speaking of guys on the field that are doing a great job, got one more highlight from you just to kind of throw it back just a little bit. Spencer Wagey coming up with a huge sack last week, a valiant effort. That's a JDP Electric highlight of the game.
On their own 24-yard line, trailing 21-7, 2:18, shotgun snap. Gronowski goes down with a sack at the 15 line. There's a host of Bison. Spencer Wagey was the first one on him.
That was Spencer Wagey, and I'm sure we'll see more of that as this season goes on. When it comes to your electrical needs, you only need one call. That's to JDP Electric. They're professionals that can follow a strict timeline and get your project done when it's needed. Call 232-1991 today to experience the JDP difference. I want to thank everybody for joining us, those that came on Facebook, joining us behind the scenes on the Horse Cam. Tune into the Insider streaming live on Facebook, courtesy of Horse Farming with Passion, online at horse.com. Also want to thank our friends at Dakota Bank. Show today made possible by Dakota Bank, one of the largest ag banks by volume, the top ag lender in the Dakotas. They are committed to the producers and families that make our communities great. Visit their new Fargo location and find out how their team is here for you. Go with commitment, experience, integrity. Dakota Bank. Matt, good to have you on. We got to do this a little bit more often. You come by about once a month or so, I believe, right?
I do. It's always a pleasure. Always look forward to it. It's always great to get out of the office for a little bit and come talk Bison Athletics. So, a lot of fun.
Well, we appreciate you. Thank you for all that you do. Keep up the excellent work. And Kyle Emanuel, been a fun one. You'll be back with us four more times this week. I got to pay him big bucks to be here.
I bet.
It's you know, I'm kind of going broke. Bridget says, we got to pay the car this month. I said, well, I got to pay Kyle Emanuel. So, you know.
Yeah, that's right. I wish.
What do we got on tap tomorrow? I just said, I'm going to throw it on you, Kyle. What are we doing tomorrow?
Oh, man, you put me on the spot like that. I don't know.
We'll I'm
prepared. You know, we'll have to see what happens tonight. Don't the Yankees, speaking of the Yankees, don't they play again tonight?
It's winter.
We got to try to close out here.
There might be some baseball talk tomorrow. We got Monday Night Football, Broncos. Let's ride, Nation. Yeah. Riding very much.
Let's ride.
I want to say this before the show. Like, why are the Broncos on prime time every week? Like, get them off. Yeah. Come on.
The new motto down there is, let's fall off. Let's fall off the horse. Let's fall off.
Exactly.
All right, been a fun one. Micah, great job. Appreciate you again. Matt Larsen, Kyle Emanuel, Rob Hipp. We'll be back on tomorrow with the Insiders.
Dakota Refrigeration has been helping the Bison succeed behind the scenes, from their training room to their dining room, from milk to medicine, from ice to ice cream. Dakota Refrigeration has been serving Minnesota, Montana, and the Dakotas for over four decades. Locally owned and operated since 1974, Dakota Refrigeration is a full-service source for your